Hey everyone, welcome to the stream. We're back in Satisfactory with our nice train building. And we've got some chill tunes to listen to.
Yep, we have chill beats to build trains and ruin planets too.
always with the environmental issues. I'm telling you, the coal is clean burning. Okay.
Big kobold over here is just suppressing the truth about coal burning.
Yes, kobold.
Okay, I did not see the pun there, but that's actually really great. Holy shit. I just realized I'm not in the game.
Yeah, let's get you in the game.
Yep, got that. I got the code right now, so I'm getting in there.
The tunes for today's stream are brought to you by Purple Cat. We did a little bit of searching around for different music options that are royalty-free. So, we love everything that this artist has produced so far, at least as far as we've heard. It is the perfect vibe, so definitely check out their Spotify and stuff. They have a lot of good shit on there. Like, it's...
Oh, yeah.
I think there's, like, probably, like, 10 hours worth of music, and it's all royalty-free.
Most of it's royalty-free.
Right. No, all the albums are royalty-free. There's a few, like, singles
exactly.
that we noticed that are, I guess, Disney-related or something. They're, like, covers. Yeah, those are obviously not royalty-free. That said, why don't we head over back to our train tracks and get going on those again?
Awesome. We can do that. Where did we park?
Well, if we pull up our map here and enable trains... way off in the middle of fucking nowhere. It's on the coast. So we're gonna need to make a new train. If we want to get there. Transport. Trains. I've got enough resources to make a train. So, yeah, let's just head... Wait, do we have enough for the tracks? Though? Oh, by the way, we did fix the problem from last time. And we, It was... Like, we got all of our inventory back. I had to do a little bit of trickery in order to do it, but...
Let me go grab a couple extra heavy modular frames. I seem to be down kind of low on them.
Oh, I also... for those of you who are interested in this sort of thing, I did rework a majority of the factory. Reorienting all the assemblers and the manufacturers, or whatever the fuck they're called. I think they're called manufacturers.
I'm never going to be able to find anything ever again.
Well, everything's in the same place. Just the buildings are oriented slightly differently so that they take up less space overall. There's less.
I see.
Yeah, so it's more compact. And I also changed the constructor lines to now also have an overflow garbage dump. So the entire factory is now never going to have any downtime. Everything will always be running.
Yeah, if we don't get breaks, neither does the factory.
Always with, like, the evil label, huh? I'm just over here like, yeah, it's more efficient. We're, like, the machines will be, producing more coupons for us. It's like, nah, they get rights. They get rights in our factory, apparently.
No, they don't. That's why I made that comment.
Oh, okay.
Is the end goal of this game to kill a god? Yes. That's... you get so productive, and you defeat entropy. God comes down to right this mistake, and we kill him. We beat him to death with our stun batons.
I don't know if that's the...
No. This is the secret... this is the secret JRPG that... We've been playing the long game.
Uh-huh. you say so. Sounds like a good time. That would be the weirdest rug pull. Just like, yeah, you're building the factory and a health bar appears on the top of the screen. Just the boss music starts playing. It's like, I'm sorry, what?
That would be amazing. I'd play that game.
It's like some of those games that don't really know what they want to be. Or are they just like jump between genres? Like, I saw a stream of Nier Automata. Where the...
Am I going the right way?
I think we are, yeah. Or wait, no, you went the wrong way.
I thought I was going the wrong way. Hang on.
Yeah.
I'll meet up with you in a second.
Wrong branch. And... So that game, all I saw was like it's mostly a battle like RPG style thing. I think I don't know exactly what the term is, but it occasionally like morphs into a like a shmup, and sometimes like it just bounces between like genres, and that I think that's fairly normal with like Japanese games, I guess, but. Still, it's just like, oh, this is the game now. Okay, I guess this is what we're doing.
Here we see a herd of numpties in their natural habitat.
Oh yeah. Oh, you just kept your jetpack on. I pull out my. God, I'm bad with words today. I pulled out my parachute for the long distance. Okay. Transport, electric locomotive.
Also, chat, if you hear me take bites of something, I'm eating a taco salad right now.
You are the quietest eater. I don't think anybody will ever hear you. Oh, we're both riding?
I can be louder. Okay.
Oh, no, never mind. All right, here we go! Don't mind me just doing a moonwalk on this.
It's a taco salad. This is not healthy. I'm eating this with greens
like
in it.
Oh, it's like beef in it and like...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, hell yeah. That, okay, never mind.
This
that,
is not
that
a healthy
great.
Option.
Oh, you heard salad and panic? Yeah, you're right. I also panicked when I heard salad.
I may as well be eating like 3 or 4 tacos right now. With what I'm eating.
Fuck yes. That sounds great. I also appreciate when you take like the normal taco ingredients and then you add like elbow noodles instead and just like make a taco pasta. That's one
Ooh,
of my
that's
favorites.
Ooh, that's good. It does have a lot of meat in it. It's honestly, the worst thing about it is it has a lot of meat right now. I prefer my taco salads to have just a little less meat, but it's really good, and someone made it for me, and you didn't have to. So it's really nice to just kind of bring that by. I'm going to take my hand off the wheel so I can eat this.
Oh, okay.
Oh, we're slowing down.
Yeah, we are. There is a train up ahead, by the way.
It's okay, we'll win.
Oh no, I fell off. That's okay. Maintain momentum. No. Uh-oh. Quick, dismantle the train. All right, we're good.
Are you, why don't you drive? I don't want to eat.
Okay.
Do the locomotion. Do the locomotion.
The first time we've tested these tracks, here's hoping there aren't any too sharp of bends. So far, so good. gosh, you're making me hungry now.
Can you hear me?
Well, no, just the I have a good imagination. All right, we should stop it about here. Because we want to keep it level at about here. All right.
Did you put the handbrake on?
It's not moving, isn't it?
Do you turn the wheels towards the hill?
No, you...
You turn them away from the hill.
We're on a downslope. You turn them away from the hill.
Yeah.
You're fucking stupid as shit on the drive test. It's like, if we're planning for the brakes to fail, we've got a problem. We've got bigger problems. You want to eat, but you haven't exercised today? I don't think that's the
that's not how this works.
Yeah, that's not the order of operations. Eat regardless of whether you've exercised and just exercise later.
Okay, oh, that's spicy.
So I think our plan was to rip up these tracks and build up a like build it more level with the top of the hill. That way we're not fucking around with all these bends and turns that are up ahead.
Well, let's see how bad the...
We still haven't figured out where we need to go. Like, that's the hard part here. Like, this is just a big old crater, and then we would have to come back up the other side. There's nothing beneficial about us going through this thing. I don't think. So. Whereas if we go over the crater... Then we just, like, come out the other side and then carry on across the land.
Hmm.
It's nearly 2 a.m.? I don't... What, so if you had exercised, you would eat at 2 a.m.? Then why don't you just eat at 2 a.m.?
Here, Mansu, I'm gonna... Here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna eat some food and you're gonna go do some push-ups. That way you can say you did both.
Opposite order, though.
Eat first, then push-ups. I'm not going back on that. I said get some food and then do some push-ups. That's what I said.
Unless it's heavy food, then do the push-ups first. We don't need you throwing up over your floor.
No. If she eats fucking a pot, like big thing of pasta and spaghetti, she's doing the push-ups after. That's how this works.
What the fuck? You're cruel. All right,
I did wrestling.
Yeah, and I did karate. What of it?
Well, it's like wrestling is needlessly cruel sometimes.
Oh,
it's just a part of the wrestling
culture. What are you doing?
I'm building an upward here. I'm building a higher plateau so that way we can curve above the crater.
Well, no, we got to go way back and start from there.
Well, I'll just hop along and I'll raise up the platforms. Unless you want to change the situation for the platforms too.
No, it's just gonna be a bridge. We don't need the platforms going straight to the ground, right?
No, you're right. Okay, I think I misunderstood your plan first, but I think I understand what you're talking about.
Oh, bring time. Is that a soda?
What?
Do you have a soda?
No.
Oh. What are you drinking out of?
Blender cup.
Ah. With ice in it?
Yeah.
That explains it. Okay.
Yeah, we're gonna need to move this bad boy back a little bit. Oh, you got rid of it.
That's alright, I just incinerated it. It's easier that way.
Okay, I think this is a good place to start.
Sleep is for the weak. I agree.
Now, let me see here. Topological data. Hang on.
What?
Could we technically circle around this to the south? It would expend a bit more of our resources, and technically would make the train have a longer path, but we could instead... No, farther south.
Here, show the stream on your map. Do you have the satisfactory, like, utility open?
No, I was just looking at the stream.
Oh, okay.
I was watching your map. So what I'm thinking is we're here, so we circle down south.
Word of warning.
We cut around the canyon.
That, like, white, deep white line with a gradient, that is the edge of the world.
Yeah, no, we just cut through here.
Uh-huh.
Where, because the topology of this strikes me that if we built up to this cliffside, like this cliff face, and we built around, we could bypass this canyon entirely and just go around.
That makes sense. The only thing that I'm worried about is that if we do that, like, part of the placement of the train so far has been to try and keep it as equally close to things as possible, and so part of that is, like, cutting the distance between the edge of the map and the middle of the map in half, sort of. Like, the useful edges, I suppose. Whereas if you do that, then you're kind of going way close to the edge of the map, rather than... which makes the center of the map harder to grab resources from.
True.
So going over this crater is most likely to be the best option for that. Long term.
Then, different plan. Because I really want to avoid this big section of winding and twisting turns.
Of course we're going to avoid them.
Yeah, let's go straight north.
No.
Why not?
That also causes the problem of us being too far away from one part of the map. Also, if we go... what do you mean? How far straight north are we going? Hold on. Show the stream.
Hang on. Yeah, no, hang on. I'm going to set a series of map markers. That'll do it.
No, you can just use your cursor. It's fine.
I wish I had, like, a pen or something I could mark this. No, I'm doing it here. So we'll start going north. We're going to travel through here. Don't worry, I'll delete all these when I'm done.
Wow.
Then we're going to travel along through here.
Uh-huh.
We're going to use the height that we have available to us by starting here to get to here.
Okay.
We're going to stretch across this. It bypasses a lot of this nonsense. We can curve down again if we really want to, or like do a smaller curve. But honestly, I don't feel a strong need to go through here. If this is the edge of the map, we may as well take this path and just save ourselves the headache.
Right. Okay, that works. Then we can cut back even more of the train and curve it towards this marker. And we don't need that one.
Okay, we can do that.
Yeah. So we go this way. Okay. I think that works. So we gotta cut back.
I'll scale this back.
Then. I'm gonna cut back to at the top of that hill. And we're gonna go along the top of the hill rather than deal with going down then back up.
Yeah, I think that's for the best. Well, I'm deleting this right here. We'll go ahead and do that. And then this right here is good. Actually, we'll delete this part.
Yeah.
We'll recurve it this way.
Readjust the curve. Yeah.
Yeah. So this is mostly fine. Now we're actually
there, and then we just work our way towards the ping or towards the pin.
Oh, there's even kind of like a natural road formation here. So that's nice.
We'll just encroach on the natives' natural. What's the word I'm looking for?
What?
Migration paths. Yeah. There are a significant number of rocks along this the landscape here. I think we're gonna have to go over them. Ow. So we might want to need to start angling up.
Okay. Oops. Let me delete this one, and then I'll raise this platform a little bit.
Yeah, I might as well do that one too. All right.
Because that way it's a more gradual curve upward.
Yeah. All right. I like that. Add a ramp on the top of them so that so it's not.
How do you want to do?
Fully level.
I see.
I think it's.
It is.
Does Monsu regularly work out? Going for those gains? Or just to maintain your perfect body shape?
I know mine is because I get self-conscious. Because, it's not like my belly or anything. I've learned more about loving myself, even though I'm a pretty plus-sized person. But, my arms used to be super beefy. Super beefy. And then ever since I started taking HRT, I've been noticing it's hard to keep them that shape. So I've been trying more frequently to... Oh, that's... this is good. Hang on. Hang on one second. I'm going to fix this.
It's not going to work. Can you just go from the previous platform to this one, or is that too long?
We'll find out. Hang on. This might actually not be that long. Let's find out.
Yeah, but we're going to be cutting down a lot of trees.
We already burned for coal and oil. It's...
You're right. The environment is already, taking a hit. We might as well just keep hitting it.
Yeah.
Not actual life advice, kids. The environment would like everything that you can give it. Let's not make this about a nihilist attitude, please.
Remember, kids, the whole world's gonna die unless corporations start changing their mind about oil.
I mean, oil is part of the problem.
Are we gonna? Do we want to talk about environmentalism on the show?
No, let's not.
Yeah. We could talk about environmentalism, but I feel like we'd be a bit in bad taste if we're doing it on Satisfactory.
I think that is a bit of a political topic, and I think we should stay the fuck away from those.
Well, I mean, environmentalism is not that big of a topic, honestly.
It's...
Okay, it's not a very contentious political topic, I should say.
People get real heated about them.
Maybe it's my world. Maybe it's just kind of like my... Maybe it's my own personal, experiences, but I usually don't find that people argue about it too much.
Well, so the arguments don't exist about whether or not... there are arguments that exist whether or not the environment needs us to improve. But they're like the bigger arguments is like what is or is not going too far, I guess. So,
I see.
Let's just drop it here.
Okay. That's fine.
There's a geyser here. What is this? This is water. Okay. Not super important.
Delete your ramp and make another foundation and then put another ramp on it because it's just a little sharp of a decline. I'm gonna put a 1 meter ramp on.
Gotcha.
So that should be fine.
And we're gonna do we really need to go around this water geyser? I think we can get water real easily from so many other sources. I don't think it's necessary. Yeah, let's just go over it.
Okay. I was gonna say, we can curve if you really want to. All I take is just leading this track.
Hey, how about we don't curve? Ever.
Alright. Yeah. Look, I learned my lesson. I'm trying my best here. I think I'm doing really well. Oh, hang on. Speaking of curves, this
okay, so that's where we might land. So
actually, I'm gonna move this over.
Is this wrong?
Yeah. I just need a. I want it to be a little bit to the right, so if I can avoid sharper curves, or if I can avoid curves at all, I'm of the mindset that I should do that. And then curves are like a necessity, not like a thing I should be striving for. So I'm just trying to get this just right.
Gotcha.
But it's what you're doing is still important, because that gives me an idea of whereabouts I should be laying the track. Not necessarily the exact
point. Why is my foundation snapping? Oh. Oh. I guess there's a... Oh, right. The world grid. God, I totally forgot about that. Okay, what direction are we going? Are we going to that one?
Everything has an objective frame point here. There's morals built into the background.
Okay.
I'm stuck in.
This is the line you want to go on. We should probably cut down some of the trees that are in the train's way, but I'm sure the train will handle them.
That's just fucking...
Okay, before we put any more tracks, let's get our bridge design. Which, concrete might become an issue very quickly. But yeah, there's a grid that just the world has, so if you did want to snap everything to the same grid, even like across the map or like really early on in the game, you could. It's like north, south, east, west oriented, and it's better way to say that, it's compass oriented, and it's perfectly like laid out so that foundations will snap to each other, even if you build them like far apart and then move them towards each other, foundation by foundation. Which is nice. Monsu may have left to go exercise.
To be fair, that's a very good reason to stop watching the stream.
Yeah.
We're gonna pull back the bridge. We're gonna have to angle this upward a different way, because I didn't realize just how tall this section of the mountain is over our section of the set.
Yeah.
We're gonna need. How much does an incline affect the speed of a train?
Very good question. I don't know if it matters. Oh, hey, there's a pancake. There it goes. But yeah, let's back off some more. I think we can do this with like 1 meter ramps.
Oh, do you wanna keep this foundation? Or do you want to delete it? Because what I'm thinking is we angle it a little bit more towards the... So, like, that.
It does still snap
way.
Slightly, so it's tough to angle it from such an... Over such a distance perfectly.
Yeah, you might be right.
Like, the angle snaps are potentially an issue.
All right. You know, you're right. That's a very good point. And I guess if we angled it towards the marker directly, we might go over some stick rocks.
I do know that... Where did you want to angle it towards? Ping it again?
Well, I wanted to go more towards, like, just straight towards that direction.
That... That is... Hold on, let's see. Let's see if we can't...
Oh yeah, let's see how
over. Yeah, that should be better.
Yeah, we can do that. Hell yeah.
We will be going over a rise and then back down, but should be fine.
I'm gonna delete this section of track and I'm gonna angle this a little bit better to meet up.
Wait. Wouldn't it be better if we is that where we wanna go? Yeah, wouldn't it be better if we went that way? Less of a height difference and on both sides that way.
Can you ping it again? I want to go there. Okay. Yeah, we could do that. I mean,
on your screen that's not on mine.
Yeah, off in the distance there. Did you delete it all?
I did. It's not on my screen.
Well, sometimes artifacts like that happen.
Early access.
Everyone sing it.
Oh, it's break time.
Oh.
Union mandated break. Let the kobolds light up.
Hell yeah.
Pause your game. Don't be building.
No, I'm just trying to.
You're just
nice
building.
You. No, I'm just. Don't worry. I'm gonna delete it. I'm doing math.
Okay. Just a quick break. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
It's like it's break time. Damn it.
It's still too long.
Learn the importance of self-care.
No.
In this game especially, self-care is so important. Oh man, we had such a great session on Sunday.
Oh yeah, we did. Can they still hear us?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, okay. So I was just like, yeah, we did have an excellent session. That was so cool. To iterate, because if we just say the word sessions, people might take this out of context somehow. So we play D&D, and Razor is my DM.
Yep.
Yeah, we do D&Ds every Sunday. We do D&Ds every Sunday. Oh, man.
Wait, sound like an old person.
I know. Next thing, do you want to go to the Walmarts? Are you playing on your Nintendos? Fucking.
Were you watching on the YouTubes?
I feel like I can do better with this track. Hang on. I feel like I can do better with the track. Do it.
I appreciate that despite us saying we were going to take a break, you did not stop attempting to solve a problem.
Well, no, I'm fuck, my voice broke.
That
the HRT might be
when
working.
You're defending yourself, huh?
Wow. Okay. First off, I was trying to figure out, mathematically speaking, how far away I could build that track from this one, and then also try to fix our angle problem. Because I didn't, like I said, I'm trying to cut down on curves. Curves right now are sort of the last thing I want. You built that foundation.
It
stuck
to
the
thing.
Oh
yeah, you're right. That is way off the left. Hang on. Okay. So if we do want to curve it a little bit in order to get it in line. So
we're trying to go over there, right?
Yes, we are.
Okay.
That should be roughly the right. No, it's not exactly the right direction. But it should be good enough.
Okay.
Yeah.
In that case, cool. Oh my god, this still looks like a fucking roller coaster over here.
It's fine, we can go back and fix it later. We just need to get we need to figure out the basic shape. Get a loop completed and then we can go back around and refine it.
You're right. I'm gonna put one more foundation. Yep, or you got that.
Oh wait, no, we gotta angle it out.
Oh yeah, go ahead.
We're gonna go 1 meter ramps.
Make kind of this, like a steady incline.
Let's make this the most gradual incline. And then we go 1 meter double ramps. The way it looks pretty.
Do you want me to try to make the track in line with the ramps and everything? Or we're just gonna...
Yeah, center in, it.
Definitely in line. Okay, hang on, I'll center it.
Hope you all are enjoying the chill tunes.
I'm not because I can't hear them.
Yeah, we're still trying to figure out all the technical specifics. There are no? You don't like the chill tunes, Monsu?
Oh.
All right, shut it all down.
Yeah, we'll all right, everyone.
It's
we're gonna take a week off.
It's a write off. delete all the episodes. We failed. I'm not a chill person. I crave violence.
Well, look. As someone who's also as someone who's also not a chill person and also craves violence, we can appreciate chill tunes, right? Like,
perhaps
we can't be 100% murder machines, right, Monsu?
Your track is curving ever so slightly. Remember,
I know. I've tried fixing it.
We have a solution to this, though.
Do we?
Yeah. Remember what we learned last time? If you build the track without previously existing track, it just draws a straight line.
Right. Hang on. Let's try that.
The music is nice.
Oh, the music is nice. Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay. We definitely didn't make it ourselves. This is made by Purple Cat.
Yeah, check out Purple Cat on Spoofy.
Mm-hmm. As a kobold myself, I can appreciate cats. Was that as nonsensical as I wanted it to be?
Maybe.
Good.
Okay. Yeah, it's in line.
You just stopped listening to some classical themed heavy metal? Oh.
Oh, like some rock orchestra, heavy metal orchestra type affair, I'm betting.
Interesting. God.
Those are so fucking cool.
I don't think music has gotten more complex. I think what's happened is just labeling has gotten more granular for music. Because, like, that sounds really, really interesting, but I bet you if I listened to it, it would just sound like music to me.
Well, see, I like to think about music and how it changes and advances because it's a cultural artifact. Its advancement is strictly in line with the technology of sound. Whereas,
yeah.
And then its development as a cultural medium doesn't really develop. Like, there's no end point to music, but it only just changes over time. So I think we're just at that point where culture is very diversified and we have an opportunity to hear all sorts of kinds of music. What is that noise?
What noise?
Don't you hear that rumbling noise?
No.
That was weird. I heard a rumbling noise. Now it stopped.
Oh, maybe there's just like a sound glitch or something. When you built the track, it played the wrong sound file. I've had that happen before with like the hypertubes, for example. It sometimes plays the freaking the soundtrack or the sound bite for the elevator, the space elevator.
All right. Since we've gotten this bridge mostly developed, let's go. Well, I want to run the train up this hill to see what we're dealing with.
Well, that's the most, the least incline we could possibly give it.
Oh, I know. I just want to see because there might be another way to solve this problem that might not involve an incline, right? I mean,
what
is there?
Do you have a teleporter in your back pocket?
Well, no, but.
I'm.
Man, there should be a fucking thing where you can, like, tackle and block style affair, except blocks a train car.
What, just an elevator?
Yeah, like an elevator for trains, a train evader.
Hey, Chad, are you part of elevator crew or escalator crew? Which one do you prefer?
Okay, look, my point is that there could totally be a. Wait, hang on, that's not looking the right way, is it? This is looking the right way. Hell yeah.
I feel like I have my video settings the wrong way.
Come on.
The feedback settings.
Come on. Nope. Stop. You're sliding. Hit the brake. Hit the brake.
Yeah, I've got TSR on.
Nope.
Oh, wait. No, I don't want it on TSR. I want it on, TSR. Oh, whatever. By the way, for those of you wondering, the game does look way nicer now, at least for me. Because of the game having been updated and all the the performance issues were fixed. So now that it doesn't hitch, I can actually run it at like a reasonably good looking settings.
Okay, I need to put this farther back. Okay. This right here will be the place where we will start this train. Okay.
Does that work?
Oh, I can't see my camera view on the stream anymore.
Oh, I hit the wrong button. Thank you. Here, let's have some melt again. I've got different seams. One for like just solo streaming, and then I've also got like the dual cameras screens, so I sometimes actually push one for single camera because we do that relatively frequently.
Okay, this...
Is it fine?
This isn't working. I need to go. I'm gonna go as far back as possible.
Wait, it's not working?
It's just not going up there. I'm not starting it far back enough. It's not getting a chance to get enough speed to clear that incline. That incline's slowing it down hardcore. So I'm gonna go back.
Bad. Like
I can't get up that incline.
What do you mean you can't?
What? I can't get up the incline in the train.
I had a no hassle getting up that incline. Hang on, let me go down further.
Well, yeah, no, I'm going here. I think.
Apocalypse this... Orchestra is the name of the band that Monsu is talking about, by the way.
Oh, okay.
Hang on, I'm gonna go further down. Before you do anything, I just want to see this for myself. I want to see what issue you were having. I went the wrong way. Hold on, it's facing the wrong way. Thank you, game. Let me delete the thing, please. Okay, now we drive it. Alright, so I'm just pressing W, not doing anything else. 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110.
It's clearing the incline?
Yeah, easy. 110 kilometers an hour up that thing.
I'm coming back up there.
Oh, okay, thank God. I was like, if the game hadn't stopped the train, I would have just gone straight into the ravine.
No. All right, hang on. Delete the train. Show me where you started from.
I started like 3/4 of the way down.
You started on the incline.
Yeah.
Am I?
Yeah.
Am I fucking in? Okay. Don't answer that. That wasn't.
Are you? Yes.
Question.
Just
put your fucking hands down. All right. Let's see here. What? Wait a minute. Stop. What the fuck was this?
I like that you got out to stop it.
Hang on a minute.
This is the skateboard.
That's true. It's a fucking... It is a freight train. You know what? Is it because this over here is too sharp of an incline?
No, it's not. Everything there is fine.
I literally could not clear this incline. I don't know what to tell you. I was having such trouble.
It seems fine now.
Look,
right,
watch this. Hang on.
Thank you, Monsu. Thank you for using only one of the many audio alerts that we have and not using any others. I appreciate it. Thank you for making all my work completely pointless. Can I say except you're welcome? Thank you. Now, how tight of a curve can we make this?
Not gonna lie, I don't like this curve, but I'm gonna try.
Well, we can back that one off a little bit so the curve is wider. larger radius. But the point is not... I don't like that this is a 45 either. I'd prefer it to be a not as much of a curve. The hard part is, though, is that I can't snap it without it being a 45. So, like, that's part of my issue here. It'd be nice if we could get this to be the same elevation and everything. Although, I suppose we don't have this, but then the bridge will look weird.
Hang on, I gotta beat this thing to death. I can't
focus. Okay, I'll just delete this.
No. Don't delete it. Don't delete it. I think I got it. You fucking goddamn it.
It's okay. I already deleted it.
Damn it. I had a plan.
Like this. Let me do. Oh, wait, no. Let me go random down.
Got a Mercer Sphere.
So excited for it.
Hey, it's one less Mercer Sphere you'll have to deal with. That'll just jump scare you out of the blue.
Yeah, I guess.
So, okay, I see what you're doing. I'm gonna let you do that real quick, Juan.
You gonna let me cook?
Yeah, I'll let you cook. And then...
There we go. This is the path that we want to roughly take here. And then from there, where are we going? Here, let me toss another radar tower down. We'll get more of the map. God damn, I don't have any cable.
Oh, look at that. That's cool.
That is ugly.
It looks like it veers off the side of it. It does, really.
Yeah. What can we do here?
Well, what we can do is we could...
Oh, that's why it's doing that. Hang on. Instead of making this a two-part curve, make it a one-part curve.
You want to just... Okay.
Yeah, just like go here, and then... Oh, no, not... Don't go straight to there. You're crazy.
That's true.
There we go. And then... Here, bring it to, like, right here.
Okay, the train track?
Yeah, bring it a little further this way.
Okay, like, so I put it right here.
The shortest curve we can go with is probably... Short. There we go. And then we can go like this. It's clipping a little bit.
That's fine, yeah.
Not gonna lie, don't think I like that.
We can delete some of this.
No, I'm not a fan. Hold on, let's try this again. Yep.
Okay.
Oh, you got rid of. All right. That's
fine. No, look. Okay, I have an idea.
Instead, we go as far this way as we need to get the curve proper, and then we ramp down.
No. Here's what we'll do. We'll take our currently existing track. We'll find a point over there. Fucking left foot.
I already fixed it.
Fine. That's fine.
There we go. And then we delete these. Not that one. Actually, we want these three bigger. Just so that it actually looks like it's supported on the ground. There we go. Okay, and then we go down. Okay.
Awesome.
Yeah, that looks good. That looks real good. Why do you keep deleting the foundations?
It's just because they clip. That's gross. I wanted to find a curve that goes
onto
the...
There's no clipping here. Look at this. It's perfectly it's perfectly clip-free.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
I mean... What, do you expect, perfection from me?
I don't... No, but what I was thinking of... was that we take it, like, part of the track from here,
Uh-huh.
And we just put a foundation right there and we just lead it over. It'll just be open air track for a second.
Open air track sounds terrifying.
Well, yeah, but the train's not gonna care. It's only gonna be for a brief gap, and then we can pretend that it's like a suspension style bridge where we'll pretend. It's fine. Look how thick this fucking train track is. This is a magnetic rail train level of thickness.
I can guarantee you that a track this thickness will not be able to support a train for any longer than maybe a year.
It's good that we have a lot of materials to replace the bomb.
You know what? I'm not interested in a yearly maintenance plan. That doesn't sound like a thing that I want in my infrastructure. Okay. So we are. Oh, do you have any cable on you?
Yeah. Why?
Can I get some? I want to toss our radar tower down so that we can expand our map in the game. Yeah. All right. Organization, radar tower, booyah, and then power, biomass burner. This thing requires how much power?
I was like, what the fuck megawatts? Was that noise? But now it's just...
Okay, it's perfect. Perfect one-to-one. All right, power line. Oh. Power line. Go. And then fuel. Now we get more of the map. All right. Cool. Okay, now we are gonna go where? We can get rid of this marker that we currently have. I feel like we make our way in this direction?
Let's see.
What's wrong? We go around the spires.
Yeah, I know. I was trying to think if there was a way we could make it work for us, and I don't think there is. So, yeah, we'll just go around.
We could like curve it so that it's not. Yeah, just go around the spires.
There's no point. I was thinking like, we're trying to go to a higher elevation point down this line again. I was like, maybe we can just build it on top of the spires, but that's a heavy incline that we don't want.
Right. Hang on. This incline is completely unnecessary. We don't need to. Sorry. We can just go straight out. You're in the way.
Mm-hmm. I'm eating salad.
Fucking herbivores, am I right?
Just call me a fucking herbivore in the middle of a fucking stream. Fucking serious right now.
Yeah, I'm calling you out. What of it?
Man, I don't think I've ever talked about my character much in the stream, have I?
Your character?
Oh
shit, I didn't even make that reference. I was just like, I don't know what I was saying, but yeah, that makes... what I said makes way more sense in that context. Man, good job, me. Sorry. Yeah, talk about your character.
I don't know. I don't want to bring it up just out of.
Too late. It's now the topic of conversation.
Oh god damn it. Well, I guess I get to rep the Caves of Quid, so. Oh, which is another thing. I'm slowly converting every player in your D&D group to a Caves of Quid player. Mm-hmm. So, slowly but surely, I'm winning them over. My character is a rendition of a character from Caves of Quid. Caves of Quid is an RPG kind of turn-based. It's not really turn-based, but style of roguelike game where you're playing in this post-apocalyptic future that's thousands of years ahead of ours. It was a post-transhumanist civilization where cybernetics and modifications were on par with things like magic.
Hold up, we're going the wrong way.
Hang on, I got
the wrong spire.
So yeah, and then it's also in a post-apocalyptic sort of sense. Somewhere along the lines, there was some cataclysmic event which devastated the entirety of. What are you laughing about over there?
Just that was an excellent recovery. Just like up and back to talking.
Well, fuck! I'm a professional. What do you want from me?
Hell yeah, you are. That was awesome.
Well, now that you did that, now I'm not fucking recovering at all. Damn it.
I had to derail you somehow. It's only a man.
Derail me. Good train joke. Anyway.
Wow, my subconscious is very clever today.
No, it's not.
Oh,
fucking
okay.
Clever. My ass. Can I fix this? Oh, come on.
What?
Ah, that's horseshit.
What?
I'm trying to build the track over here. I'm trying to get as short of a curve as possible. But I can't just connect. I can't connect on that conveyor belt. I have to make it a certain length.
Right.
So I'm trying to balance how hard of a curve.
I think if you go so because we have a perfect like angle here. If you want to make it a perfect angle, stop this track at the edge of one foundation and then start the other track at the same edge on the other line. That way it'll be like a perfect curve.
Well, the thing about, hang on. So like right here or like farther away?
Well, let's see if this one would work. But what I'm saying is, my screen. Since you've got this one kind, what is that? 1, 2 away. Go. So this is the center point. 1. Yep. Oh, I see what's happening here. Hang on. I see what's happening here.
Oh no.
Blame Monsu. There. And then
it's nice to be on the other side of
too sharp. So then we let's go to the edge of the foundation. So we go to this edge.
Uh-huh.
We drag it over this way, and then we make this one also on the edge. So like here? I think that's the same edge. That is the same edge. And then we just connect them. And there we go.
All right.
Perfect curve.
Oh, wow. Okay, that did work. See, I was trying to get the curve right, but I kept telling me the track was too short.
Yeah. You got to figure out what is long enough for the track, right? When we do these, any curves, so even like vertical like transitions, so changing to a ramp, if we can make those as short as possible, that would probably make things look a lot nicer.
True. I see what you're saying.
I mean, not that short. It's gonna clip.
Well, no, what? Because what? No, it's not gonna clip.
It's
like,
clipping.
Watch this. It's not gonna act like you're watching.
Oh, okay. You sure? So curvy.
See, it's perfect. Fucking stupid ass tray. It's fucking. Whose idea was this?
Mine. I'll take full responsibility for the mistakes of my past. Yeah, just go. No, Penelope.
Don't you fucking call me Penny. I'll murder you.
Just go like a couple foundations up and then carry on from there.
Okay. Fun fact, I don't like being called Penny. I prefer Penelope. Mm-hmm. And I hate it. This is more for the stream than for you. You already know.
Oh, yeah.
But I detest the nickname Penny.
Instead of going right to the top of the ramp, go to like...
Oh, sweet niblets.
Go one below and then curve it, and I'll take care of this fucker. How much foundation you got, by the way?
How much concrete, you mean?
That, yes.
924?
Okay.
I've got a good amount. Here, why don't you take it, because you're building. You're building bone foundation, so you take the concrete. Okay. I'll give you the full stack, and then just in case I need to make some on my side as well.
Okay. You think that'll curve just one foundation to one foundation up? Yeah, it'll work nicely. Just go like now. Just go right to here, right here.
No.
Go to the. Make it. No.
Woo!
No, you go.
There.
Did you go yeah, you did. It's clipping!
Oh my god! I've spent several minutes trying to fix this. But it's just like, no, you gotta do it this way. No, you gotta do it this way. No, we're doing this Penelope's way. It's clipping a little bit, because that's an optimal train curve. And you know what? This is a video game. Fuck you!
Yeah, so there's a video game about satisfaction.
Oh, no. Suppress. Remember your blood pressure. Your blood pressure.
I'm satisfied when your blood pressure is very high.
Oh. Oh, no. Angus Bunger, I'll put you 6 feet under.
I have no idea what you just referenced. another days of our hard work.
Are you just feeding off of my rage? Is this your fucking content click? It's like, man, I bet if we rebranded as a rage channel, but it's just you adding me, I bet people would flock to this channel.
Oh my god. Me adding you? Is that one of our compilation titles now? Just fucking every time one adds the other?
No, it's gonna be fucking. They're gonna do one where it's an entire compilation of you adding me because it happens so much more often.
Yeah,
oh fuck me sideways. This is gonna clip.
And hold up, I'm trying to figure out the exact shape here. Before you do all of that.
Alright, clips.
No,
it's fine. I got an idea.
Oh, you do? Because yeah. I think we need to pull this ramp back by about like 5 foundations.
I'll take it back by 5 foundations?
Yeah.
I should still have the room for it.
Yeah, that should be about the right amount. So we're gonna redo this ramp.
Oh, the whole thing? Okay. I'm sure there's like a there's probably if I actually took notice of it, there's probably like a way to remember the good spline curve and how many foundations it takes in an incline to hit that spline, that perfect spline.
What do you mean?
Oh, well, because like it like from like here to here, if I start the train track here, and I move
and
up the foundation,
and then go up to no, go 1-to-1 for the upwards, it's 1-to-1. So, excuse me, what I mean is one foundation to one foundation up.
Oh, I see what you're saying. It's linear. Okay.
Alright. Yeah, just keep the ratio at the corner the same. So however many foundations you start the curve is how many foundations you end the curve into the ramp. And same way this way, though I think this way, this side, it's like one foundation to one foundation.
I see what you're saying.
I think that's how it works. Though this is a sharper ramp. This is a sharper incline that I'm doing right now. I'm not sure if we want to change that, but.
Well, we'll do the train check again. Whoops. That's better.
Currently, I'm trying to figure out how to get this train check to fucking line up. I need to go back one more. So close.
All right.
I can
now,
almost taste it.
Now I have a qualm here. We should have like banked turns for trains.
Banked?
These mean? like you know how these have to be level to the ground and like they have to be like flat. Well, if this takes a little bit of imagination. So hear me out on this.
Okay.
We do. The trains in this game should work more like roller coasters.
Wait, so you mean you want the track to be like angled, like rolled?
Yeah, like yeah, like bank the turn, so that way it,
well,
it's like
the game doesn't let us do that.
Well, the thing is, it should.
This is a high-powered train. It doesn't. And do we know if monorails ever do that?
Well, this is the future.
You're right. How silly of me to not consider the argument that this is future time, so anything's possible.
We literally do hypertubes and stuff, but you don't call the like. There's a suspension of disbelief here. And yours is that they don't work like fucking. Like we can't have trains that work a little more like roller coasters. Two things that already exist that have very similar sorts of structures. If albeit trains aren't made to bevel and bank like that. I feel like I've lost you. So we're along this way.
I'm just like, yeah. Yeah, I guess. You're right.
Well, I'm just thinking about.
I think that the main reason why real world train like monorails don't do that is because curving a thick ass rail is probably a nightmare. In like, I mean, they already do it in like one axis. Doing it in two axes would be probably the roughest thing ever. Like, you would need such a complex machine, and like the machine would probably have to be purpose built. For each of the, for, like, every time it needs to be used.
Well,
that would be terrifying to me.
Well, look, I get it. But
oh, Jesus, this is a complex curve, isn't it?
But the rule of cool is super important to me here. It's not. Yeah,
yeah,
hang on, we're gonna have
down
to fix
further.
This.
There's kind of a gap going on there.
Yeah, I'll chop it off a little bit. Thankfully, I gave myself a little wiggle room. Mm-hmm. So, what I mean to say is, what was that?
I don't know. I was being cute or something.
Oh, you do that already. Gosh.
Anyways.
God damn it.
All right.
Just like, okay, we'll just move on.
Yeah, I think we've had enough.
Well, look. My point is, I think the rule of cool is more important here than strictly following physics. If we can have hypertubes and we have a space elevator, mind you, space elevators are based in physics. I understand
that.
Yeah. We have the physics for a thing that could potentially be like a rail. And like a gyroscope, where it's like, instead of having a train track along the ground, we suspend a train from a rail, and it follows that along. And then if it needs to bank a turn, you just do that. And you can use like physics and keep it like the stuff inside the contents of the train level to the bottom of the car. Or, you know,
right.
We could just pretend it's all strapped down.
Here's,
you know,
here's an interesting, unfortunate point here, though. You would
okay.
have to design the curve in order for the forces to work the way you want them to and keep things roughly level. You would need to design the curve according to the speed of the train that is traveling along it. Now, the problem there is that trains regularly are iterated on and improved upon. But the tracks themselves tend to be standardized. So, like, and not to mention, like, safety standards could change, things like that. Like, who knows? So, the fact that you're, like, expecting this train to be traveling at the same speed along the curve is tricky. That's why...
You're pulling too much real-world stuff into it. I'm just trying to...
Oh,
I'm
that's
just
where
trying
we draw
to pull
the line?
Well, look.
Just keep building the track while we talk.
Oh. Well, you've been standing there. I don't know where the curve is going to be. I'm just trying to think about
go,
it.
Go two foundations down, click, and then actually do the curve from there. Also, look at this. I figured out how to make it look real nice. Look at this. It's gorgeous. The foundation.
I see it. It looks nice.
Yes, dear, that looks nice.
No, I'm not. I don't want to plague you. I was just like, yeah, it's good. It's good. It's nice. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry, hon. Jesus, I'm sorry.
I don't take anything seriously during this stream.
Hell yeah.
Oh, okay, never mind. I take that seriously. That I take seriously. Good God. I don't think this is going to work because we're curving in two orientations, two directions.
Then we'll have it free floating for a minute. And we'll
We can just like quickly fix this. There's a way to fix this. We just do this. All right. We just go like this. And then we take this. We go one, two, three this way. Okay. And then now we can curve one way and then we curve the other way. And then we just reposition the ramp. Actually, now that we have this in place, why don't we just use a lower incline? Yeah, let's do that. I won't delete it. Oh, you're doing that? Okay. I'll be inclined. I was like, you're about to land somewhere where I've currently got it highlighted red.
No, I was just flying along.
Foundations.
Aw, fuck. Okay.
This is what happens when both of us are both building and dismantling. It's not something we can avoid, though, so it's not like we're going to fix it. Use the double ramp. The 2-meter double ramp.
2-meter double ramp, okay.
Because that way it adds a ramp underneath as well, so that it looks like a fully complete, like, ramp rather than a like stair step underneath, and then just zoop. Oh, you're starting in the wrong place though. Here, come up here and build it downwards. We don't know where it's going to intersect at the bottom until we intersect.
2-meter double ramp. Cool.
Heck yeah. Zoop! Zoop!
I should switch to zoop.
Oh yeah, that's satisfying. I'll get rid of the ramps underneath, or the foundation underneath. Oops. Hell yeah, that's nice. Okay, now we build this to here, and then we build it up to, where'd the line go? Oh, there's a line.
So mad.
There, and then we go all the way up. What are you mad about?
I'm mad because you don't like my roller coaster idea.
I think your roller coaster idea is amazing. And if it were
possible... No, you
possible,
don't. You were fighting me super hard on it.
I don't know. I have trouble separating realism from the fun.
Well, suspense of your disbelief there. We're suspended... Look, we're floating on a piece of concrete, like...
Yeah,
how many feet in the air?
I don't see a problem with this. It's a
roller coaster.
It's a on both ends.
That's no. Don't stop it. Don't stop it. Look.
Hey, there's probably like a concrete material in the future that's capable of sustaining this level of load.
In the future, huh? I told you that. And you're in the future.
I never claimed to not be a hypocrite.
Oh, listen here, you little shit. Look.
Go to the edge of the foundation, right here. Yeah.
Am I there?
No.
No?
There. Yeah.
But look, all I'm saying is I kind of like the idea of playing Drillville once you get to this part of the game, you know?
What, just like having the train be an actual roller coaster?
Isn't that fun? Like,
there
I know
it
it's stupid, but...
It's fun as hell. I just don't think it's, like, in the same realm of As the game it has been up to this point. I think that'll be too sharp of a curve. One foundation is too sharp.
Too sharp. Yeah.
Go like halfway into the middle of the foundation. Yeah, you got it. And then try that. And then, we gotta rebuild this one now.
Well, fuck.
Hang on, I got it.
All right.
Got it.
All right.
Hang on, I got it.
Do you got it?
I got it.
All right, good.
I didn't get it. In the wrong place. That's also in the wrong place. Hold on, let me aim myself first. And then I will start building. So right here. Yeah, that's right. Okay. Then I'll make it as long as possible so that we don't have too many joints. Long. There. Okay. You can connect.
Heck there we go.
This is going great.
Just bitter discontent.
I know. I was like, this is going great. And I could just imagine you just over there with like a sour look on your face.
You imagined correctly. You felt it.
I appreciate that we're both cartoon characters.
God damn. I think something about this game really... Because like, you can be smart about this game, and I think... you can really develop some really cool stuff, but I just feel like when we're trying to build things, it's pointless to be inefficient, and I hate that. Like, I feel like inefficiencies can breed creativity, even if you're perfectly inefficient in some video games, you can still have fun with it.
Just
being kooky or whatever. But I feel like there's no fun to be had in inefficiency here.
I disagree.
You think so?
I think the fun comes from other places than what you would normally expect. Because, and I don't know. This is a super nerdy thing to say, but it's like, there's a level of fun in, like, learning or something new or improving yourself.
Well, yeah, no. Like, and I get that. It just feels like...
But yeah, I guess you're right. Like, doing it wrong doesn't feel good in this game.
Well, yeah, because it feels like there's a right way and a wrong way to do it, and that always jives. Like, if I'm doing a puzzle game, it makes sense that there's a right and a wrong answer to a puzzle or a question or a riddle or something.
Yeah.
Because the joy of playing a puzzle game is figuring that out. But figuring out the right and wrong way to do something in this game involves hardcore physics that I don't really understand all that much. Or, like, it's doing math and stuff, and it's like...
I mean, a little bit. It's really just figuring out patterns is the way that I've kind of handled it. Everything else is not really a hard thing to do.
Well, yeah, no, I mean, it's not hard, but it's certainly not... I don't know. I really like an idea where a game has... See, my big thing about video games... is that when two systems interlock with each other in a certain way, it creates emergent gameplay. Mm-hmm. Like, so, I think what a lot of video game developers don't understand about video games in general is that you can make something complicated, but that doesn't make it fun. If you make simple systems and then they interlink to create depth, that's fun. It's interesting.
I see that.
And this game to me feels like it has a lot of complexity, and then, you know, like the game's fun is from its know-how and its understanding of how to bring all these resources together and manage everything and sort of escalate this giant monumental factory. But I just feel like I'm not getting the point where it's like all interlocking together. I feel like what this game in my mind would really benefit from is some things that would improve the fun-to-fun moments, like the moment-to-moment gameplay.
Okay.
This game's almost entirely focused on the long game right now, like the long sort of experience.
Yeah.
Which I get it. It's in the name. It's satisfactory.
Yes, and to be fair, like this game is designed for a certain type of person. Where, like, I personally am here because for the joy of every single time I reach a new milestone in the factory. And everything leading up to that is like, little milestones, you know? So it, like, plays super well to my ADHD because I can, like, break things down into super manageable chunks. And yet still, like, feel that satisfaction of, like, yeah, I did this today, I did this. Like, and things have been done, and I feel accomplished. You know, like...
I don't. I have the opposite ADHD.
Oh.
Long-form task... Like, I don't get satisfaction.
Well, you know what we're doing right now, right? Like, what the goal is?
Of course, we're building this massive train track to encircle areas to improve our logistics in a way. Like, be able to maneuver resources around the map better. And yeah. I get that.
Well,
that's a good point.
Then we'll have a train that we can ride around on whenever we're feeling like not doing something.
Well, yeah, I don't know. There's something I always struggled with about completing a task, where it's like, so, like, for the longest time, I've always been told, like, don't you ever feel, like, pride or satisfaction for, like, a job well done, mm-hmm. or, like, doing something, but I don't.
Huh.
I, like, when I complete a task and, like, I finish it, I don't feel any sort of dopamine. I'm just sitting like, okay, I got this out of the way, and now I can go do other stuff. And then I will instantly move away from it. Oh shit, I'm coming. Right. So like, I totally understand the importance of this task. And I totally understand why it makes logical and logistic sense. I'm not, mm-hmm. I'm not like,
okay.
No,
well, so you're not a builder.
Not really, no. I mean,
okay.
I'm more of a puzzler. Like, if there's an interesting problem, and I can find a solution that will work, even if it's the most mangled solution. I typically like to enjoy that sort of gameplay, or like sort of experience where it's like, hey, this is a puzzle, and there is a right answer. It just might be really convoluted.
Okay, so, well, why don't you take control of where this train is going then?
Well, that's not gonna...
Not at the point.
It's just it doesn't do anything for me. I mean, I can still kind of have fun with it. Like, I like having fun smacking things with my baton.
Okay.
But I think it's just sort of like our brains. I think our brains are differently ADHD'd.
Well, there's that. I'm also a maker. Like, I enjoy building things and having something in my hands that has been crafted by myself.
What's your Myers-Briggs?
I don't know what that is.
You don't know what the Myers-Briggs test is?
Well, I've heard of it. I think I might have done it before. I don't know what mine is because that seems like a weird thing. That's like knowing your IQ. I mean, come on.
That's true.
It's also like a very nebulous and could easily have been tested wrong. So I don't know. That seems like putting yourself into a category that's it feels about as impactful as like a star sign.
That's true. I don't know. I think I put a lot of faith into it when I was younger and I didn't know any better, but I also thought it was interesting to like try to identify aspects of someone's personality or their defining nature. It's like I think it could be useful in some not super important stuff. Where it's like, you know, it's based on like you have to self answer questions and like self report different aspects of your personality, which
yeah.
I think can help someone at least think about themselves in a specific way.
There's radiation over here. There's radiation. I'm not a huge fan.
Oh no.
Where is it coming from? Like,
anyway,
is it underneath? Oh, it's underneath. Oh, it's a big old uranium rock there. Okay.
Like, how bad are your? How bad for radiation?
Just a little.
Just a little. It is.
It gets.
We'll build fast.
it gets worse as you get further in. Ooh.
Oh, does it? Hang on.
Ooh. This might not be the best route all of a sudden.
Well, I did bring something along to help us with our journey. I brought the Nobilisk.
I don't think that gets rid of that doesn't get rid of the uranium.
Oh.
It could get rid of like explodable rocks, but that doesn't get rid of the uranium ore. Well, all right.
Sorry, I was dealing with a numpty.
You know what? I feel like that's warranted.
Oh god, it's coming back. All right.
Okay. Well, then which direction do we go from here? I felt like this was the right answer, and then now suddenly it's not. God, radiation. That's just a nuisance at this point.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
so this sort of problem solving, not doing it for you?
Well, let me think about it for a minute. I mean, it might be a lateral puzzle problem here. Let's see. So we can't go this way. Oh, we can't go this way because the uranium does get worse across the bridge. Mm-hmm. Can't go under because there's also a uranium rock down there. Uh-huh. Or down there. What about, what's our other options here? We're currently moving northeast. If we try to... We could go around this rock by going and following this path here, and then we can use those two rocks there to bridge over the chasm somewhere down in that direction. I couldn't tell you exactly where.
So then we just skirt through the through this ravine.
Yeah, we could descend mid-air. Down into the ravine.
Nah, midair.
Oh, you want to do it? Yeah, we'll do midair.
Oh,
that's good.
Ah, jeez. No, you're right. This does change things because I was hoping that we would go. All right, that was a weird thing to see just on the edge of the map. I was hoping that we would go over this bridge, over this ravine, around here, over here, and then through there. And then like,
oh,
over,
I see what you're
yeah,
saying.
So we had like a nice scenic waterfall to just like bridge around.
Well, I mean, what we could do is we could run back and we can get the radiation suits. We have radiation suits now, don't we?
Nope. That's not unlocked yet.
Well, why don't we... Look. I know this is going to sound like we're stopping the project right now, but why don't we go take care of that? Because I'm pretty sure with the resources we have available...
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, and then we'll clear some radioactive spots because I don't want that to stop the train.
Okay.
You know. Are you building a train? All right, you drive. But yeah, no, it's always something that's been like a problem.
Nah, it's cool. Maybe I've been taking.
Fuck! Come back!
Maybe I've been taking too much of the reins here. I do.
Well, the thing about it
is that.
Well, the thing about it is that even if it had been different, you know, I don't think it would have mattered. Like, the fact that this factory exists is not because of my direction. Like, if I had been making... Oh, that's a fucked up turn.
What do you mean? It was perfect on my side.
I know, but it's just like that sudden shut. Oh my... Anyway, but like, the fact that this factory is built is because you had a lot of creative control over everything. Like, you made decisions about layouts and such.
Uh-huh.
And that's cool, and I think that's fine. I just... If I had been trying to do that, I feel like this factory would never have been built. I think the biggest part of it for me is also like if I like Factorio is easier for me to eat and digest.
Uh-huh.
Where it's because everything's all in front of me and I can start thinking about it more naturally. I don't really gel with Factorio's gameplay super well either, but I can rock it more easily. But yeah, no, I just kind of struggle with getting enjoyment with that sort of gameplay loop.
Okay, makes sense.
I mean, what about you? Like, you said this, you're a builder, right?
Yeah, I love this game.
Well, do you play other games like, I don't know, like City Skylines and stuff? Or?
I tried it before.
Well, how'd that work out?
Hit a logical stopping point.
Oh, I see. But did you, like, enjoy it from the time you had it?
Yeah.
Okay.
The logical stopping point was, this game is chugging all of a sudden. Like, that was a stopping point for me, because it was just like, my city is suddenly too big for my computer to handle, or something.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I could probably play further now that my computer is the way it is. It's been upgraded, but you know what? I don't feel a need to. Meanwhile, I've played through this game like 3 or 4 times now. And this game is great to play through every time, because it's, I don't know, just like those city builder games, so like SimCity at first and then City Skylines and stuff like that. I always had a really tough time figuring out like what's the route that I like to take through the city building process, because it's really fucking complex. Like, there's so many things you're juggling in those sorts of games, whereas in a game like this, everything's really linear. Like, you do this, then this, then this, then this, then this, and there's like no, like, sure, you can make decisions as to what you do first, but like everything contributes to everything else. So
I see what you're saying.
There's no decision you make that is likely to cause you to lose progress, right? Whereas with City Skylines, it's like, yeah, you could run out of money. Don't run out of money.
Yeah, don't run out of money. I don't know. I think City Skylines is always one of those games for me. It's like, I like to invent little challenges for games sometimes, where it's like, hey, I like to play a game and be able to enjoy the added benefit of replayability when I do a new challenge. Because that adds a lot of replayability for me. So like City Skylines, I like to try, one of the ones that I've seen is you try to hit a certain amount of money within a year. Those are always kind of interesting and fun, because people have little ways to win max. Some of them is like having a certain amount of ratio of water to land, where it's like getting harder and harder to manage your resources. Those are fun.
I mean, I don't have a terribly large amount of fun replaying the game in like normal settings. I don't like imposing artificial challenges on myself. That's something that is, like, I've never really enjoyed in most video games. Like,
I see.
There's of course, like, difficulty challenges. So, like, increasing the difficulty in Halo, for example. Like, that's a challenge that I can actually enjoy, because it's, like, skill improvement. Like, directly skill improvement. It's not just, I don't know. Games that are too complex don't need to get more complex, in my mind. Like this game, I wouldn't enjoy any extra challenge to this.
I'm going the wrong way, aren't I?
I don't know. Which way are you going?
Well, I went along the power line.
Ah, you took the power lines. I see.
Well. Oh, I'm right nearby you.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Hypertube.
I'm going the right way.
This hypertube is slow. The cannons were not sufficient. Yeah, I don't know. I've got different classes of games that I enjoy depending on my mood. This game I just most often will enjoy because, I don't know, it just feels right to be able to make progress and stuff like that, because there's so many things in my life that are so tough to check off of my to-do list that it's like, yeah, I can just like get that sort of dopamine hit for to-do list stuff from this, I think. I still don't know what exactly dopamine feels like, but I assume that this feels good, so it's probably the right thing. Meanwhile, it's like, yeah, I can't go back to Factorio now that I played this game.
Oh, yeah, this... I get that. Nah, that's fair.
Factorio is one of the games where, like, I played it once. I enjoyed playing it once. Like, all the discoveries and, like, the The experience of like figuring things out for the first time was great. But then I started playing it a second time and I was like, ah, this is so unpleasant to go back to like not having all the things that are actually enjoyable once you're at a certain skill level.
Oh yeah, no, I think the biggest draw for me for Factorio is that the game is responsive to your level of gameplay. Like where this game always feels like, environmentally speaking, there's a difference between what biomes you're in, and there's tougher enemies based on that. But
are you talking about the pollution system in Factorio?
Yeah, I love the pollution system.
I couldn't care less about it. I'm not.
Wow.
I detest the fact that game is a base defender game.
Oh, the hyper tubes are working a little better for me now.
Oh, good. Yeah, I'm just over here. I'm just over here like, stop breaking the shit that I spent hours figuring out. Like,
that's totally fair. But that's part of the reason why you have to balance your factory. It's like, okay,
it's just extra complexity. I don't know. This is
well,
way more
it's
chill.
So cool. Well, yeah, I guess it is more chill. But the reason I enjoy one over the other, the reason I enjoy Factorio, I think, more than this is because you know you're on a time limit and you know that you're the one causing it to go down. So you have to find the right balance between making weapons or like laser weapons and managing your power and then managing the materials to managing the things to process things. And you also have to figure out the logistics of your factory. You have to keep building. You have to keep building.
Yeah, I'm very much not a fan of time crunches. I do not like a game that forces me to play at a speed that I'm not comfortable with. Also, hazmat suit, we definitely are not going to be capable of getting.
Why not?
Anytime soon, unless we switch our focus to expanding and upgrading the factory.
What's the material needed for the
aluminum casing?
We're gonna have to build stuff, don't worry.
Yeah. Here, let's get bauxite refinement sorted out. So I've got that selected right now, which I know on your screen you have it. Oh, it's underneath picture in picture. Whatever. Yeah. I don't know if you wanna. You already got it. Wow, so fast. And then I guess we could set up a temporary skip. So we could get some aluminum casing going. In order to do that, though, we'll need to actually find and mine aluminum, like bauxite, on the map. Which I guess we have radar towers for, so hold on, let me check out the resources. Look for bauxite now. Bauxite, that's Catherium. Iron. Is there no bauxite in range of any of our shit? Hold on. Let's see where the bauxite pings. Did we get some? Oh, there's a ping. Oh, the radars aren't picking them up. Weird.
Oh.
Okay, well, there's three of them over there. So if we want to make a bunch of aluminum casings, what we gotta do, so we need, how many aluminum casings do we need for this? 50. Okay, so then I grab 50 aluminum casings and put them in my to-do list. Okay, we need 75 aluminum ingots. We cannot make aluminum ingots in the thing. Okay, so then we add 76. Which means we need 114 aluminum scrap. Now, aluminum scrap we have to make in the refinery, which is a nuisance. So if we were to pull out a refinery, oh, We have access to the Blender now. It's great. We can make some dope animations.
Joy upon joy. Rapturous day.
Hey, do you want to...
Kaluga.
Would you prefer to figure out the production here, or would you prefer to go and get the bauxite?
I think I'd prefer to crawl up in a ball and cry.
Okay.
Just...
Because I'm thinking, like, pick. We could do this. It's just going to be a slight amount of manual work. By slight,
your
I mean...
Pick. It's fine.
More significant than we were expecting.
If I let my brain put up a fight, I'm just going to be mad about it. Let's do it.
Okay. So we would need to make... Oh, God. This is what I was dreading about aluminum. So in order to make aluminum, you first need to take some bauxite. Then you need to combine it with some water to make alumina solution, a fluid. And then you take the fluid alumina solution, and then you combine that with coal. I think that's coal. Hang on, let's find out. Yep, coal, to make aluminum scrap. And then you take that aluminum scrap, you combine that with, where is it? Silica to make aluminum ingots, and then from there we would need to then convert it, the aluminum ingots, into aluminum casings. Like, even just getting the raw ingots takes like 4 steps.
Why? Why?
This is like the
Why
end
does
game.
It require the. No! That's horseshit! Who would design. That's not how aluminum is made, is it? This is a. Like, because if that's how aluminum's made, I'm pretty sure aluminum's not fucking real.
Okay.
Right?
So,
like, no.
Here, let me explain. So, in the real world, aluminum is a pure element, right?
Yes, it's on the periodic table of elements.
Yeah. So, the objective then, when refining aluminum, is to remove impurities, right? So, I would assume that this process is actually pretty. Straightforward, like, or this is as accurate of a process as any other process would be. I'm sure, like, with other metals, you could, with aluminum, just melt it down and then skim away the impurities. But I bet that doesn't work perfectly well with aluminum, because aluminum has a very it transmits heat really. Well, I don't know. Do we want to look up how aluminum is refined in real life?
No, I want to cry. Why? So wait a minute. So to do any of the thing we need to do to get the hazmat suit, to continue the train, we're going to need to
We can figure out another solution to the train situation. We don't have to get a hazmat suit.
But I like that scenic idea you had there. It's cool. I like that.
Well, so the train will only be passing through that space for a very short period of time. So it's not a long-term solution. The only issue that we're it's not a long-term issue. The only issue we're experiencing right now is building it, right? So.
Well, yeah, but even after we build the train, we're gonna have to figure this out, right?
Well, yes, we will do this after the train.
It's just.
Yeah, I'll admit the late and the end game of this game is a lot. It's a lot. This game ramps in quote unquote difficulty with every stage of the space elevator, with every stage of the race. So. Yeah.
Just I feel my soul breaking apart.
Well, here, let's think, of, like... think of this. Like, so tier 1 and 2 were just, like, building the factory. Just, like, simple shit you can think of. Tier 3 and 4, you started incorporating a steel, which is two ores that have to be combined with each other. So that increases complexity. So just combining parts, so suddenly you have to deal with two conveyor belts per building, right?
Okay.
Tier 4, the complexity increase was Tier 5, excuse me, was oil production, which, as we saw, requires refineries, and suddenly you are balancing, you have to balance your outputs, because otherwise you are, your factory stops running if you have too much of one thing and not enough of another. So that's the progression there. And so now we are at tier 7, which is the difficulty class is just everything all at once. Plus extra. Plus ultra. So we incorporate the blender into the mix. Like we now have a process to make aluminum that's going to require several steps. And so the game kind of slows down after each space elevator upgrade, you know? So it is it is really unfortunate that in every tier we get to, basically, we have to reimagine our current production line. Because tier 5, we had to incorporate a whole separate oil processing building into the mix, which wasn't terribly hard. Tier 3, we had to incorporate coal and steel mining, which wasn't actually that difficult. Honestly, tier 7 and tier 8 are just hard. This is hard mode. Welcome to hard mode. You wanted hard mode? We got hard mode.
I didn't want hard mode.
Oh, you didn't want hard mode.
This is okay. I like hard modes of video games. This is the height of tedium.
Yes. If you think of it like that, yeah. But it's also just like a thing where you don't have to do it all at once. You don't you can just chip away at it. This is slow and steady game. So I guess, yeah, you're right about this. This is long game stuff. I don't know. I came into this with a skill set that was perfect for this game because I had already gone through a couple years of engineering school and programming knowledge and all these other things. And so this is nothing to me. The amount of tedium that this game has is nothing compared to building a program from scratch. I will be that for a video game or a for a robot or any other purpose. Programming requires this level of complexity where you're going from very simple concepts, but you have to build everything with the intent that it needs to fit with something very late on in the production process. The idea is otherwise you're just causing a whole bunch of recursing and having to redo things over and over again.
Well, no, I get that. I do.
That's why programmers use modularity in their programs. They keep subsections of the program as their own dedicated things. That way you don't have to redesign the whole thing. If you do the same thing over and over and over again, you just take that thing, you put it in a container, and then you just feed it the things it needs every time you need to use it. So we've already kind of done that. And this, as much as, yeah, that sounds like a lot of work, and yes, in this moment, if we wanted to get hazmat suits today, we probably wouldn't be able to. But it's a whole bunch of stuff that we can unlock once we do that. So there's the reward, which is we get Mark V conveyor belts. The hazmat suits are, of course, lets us start using uranium. One of the things we can get is drones, so we can just transport resources through the air, not having to build any infrastructure between the two points. That is a really awesome thing to be able to do. Hover pack?
Oh yeah.
It's like a jet pack, except it's electricity powered. So as long as you're near a power line, you just have infinite flying.
That's, yeah.
It's just I don't know. You ever done achievement hunting or anything like that, where it's
I do speed running and stuff and achievement hunting.
No, achievement hunting. No, it's not speed running.
Oh yeah, no. I get the achievement hunting
Yeah.
I don't know. I just.
It's the completionist attitude. It's I'm doing this thing just to say that I did it. You know. That's what we're at this point in the game, because you're right. We could just stop playing right now. We could have also stopped playing 100 hours ago.
Well, I know. It's just, I'm not, I think I'm being a sourpuss. It's fine.
If you know what? If this is not your game and like we're learning this now, like that's fine.
No, it's not like that. I've had like fun with this game. We'll talk about this off stream. Let's try our best
to
point ourselves at a goal and attack it.
Do we want to go back and deal with and keep doing the train? Keep it nice and simple.
We'll get that job done,
and then we can focus on upgrading the factory after that.
Okay.
Do you want to tackle it from the opposite direction? That way, all we have to do is connect the two over that shitty uranium deposit.
Yeah, sure. Do we know where the other end is?
Yeah, it's over by the oil or the fuel production for the tight turbo fuel.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Hang on. Okay, let's go.
Flip.
Well, it didn't work for me. Fuck.
Anyo!
I gave the game too much credit. Oh, fuck me, it broke. I fucking froze it in midair now.
Oh, no! Alright, disconnect and reconnect. Shit.
But yeah, no, I think it's just a lot of stuff here where I'm just like not... No, we'll talk about this off stream.
Yeah, I know.
You know, I bet that a lot of my gripe with this game will be solved when the story and stuff comes out, because then to feed my curiosity about the rest of the game, it's like, oh yeah, I want to get more story. And in order to do so, it's like, oh yeah, I'll just focus on trying to build up like the factory and like try to figure out, oh, in order to go get that story, I need these resources. So I think that might be a little bit better for reinforcing what I need to do. But also doesn't help the fact that it's just like, oh, there's like, I need to run aluminum through water, and I need to go get the bauxite out of the ground, and then, ah, fuck me! The game tried to kill me. Oh, fine, I'll stop talking shit, game, whatever.
Are you just gonna run the whole way?
I'm not going back in there. I have to run back the whole way.
It would be faster for you to just re-enter the hypertube and just at a slower speed.
I know, but sometimes I'll just hit my head in that anyway. I'm just gonna run it. That's fine.
Alright.
Yeah, whatever. I'm complaining about playing video games.
Hey, you know what? I've been in your shoes before, where this game has kind of gotten tiresome, or whatever the fuck the word is, and it's like, yeah, you know what, I'm done, and then I like stopped playing it for a year, and then I came back to it when the updates had made things better, and it was like, holy shit, and I played the game again and did things better that time. Like, I've never played this game through to completion then stopped or played this game through to completion and started playing a new game immediately after the previous one. This game is...
Oh, that'd be awful.
Yeah, no, I don't do that. Just like every video game, this game has like a lifespan before you get tired of it, and then you need to stop playing it for a certain amount of time and before you can play it again. You know, some games, that length of time that you need to stop playing it for is decades. Others, it's like a couple months. So, yeah, whatever.
Oh yeah, I get it. I'm just sitting here like, beans. I think I've hit this saturation point with this game. It's like, you know, I feel like I've gotten a lot done, or at least I feel like I've just gotten stuff that I wanted to do done. But I think there was a certain mysticism I had with this game going into it, where it's like,
I was gonna say, you're just walking towards the turbo fuel when you could just have split off and gone towards the fuel.
Well, I guess I'll take this hypertube.
Okay.
But there's a certain mysticism that I held towards this game. Mm-hmm. Because, like, I played this game, like, once before, you and I met, where it's like, it came out, and it was like, wow, this is... And then, of course, I knew it's been gathering updates all this time, it's been developing. And it's this cool thing. Wait, is it this second tube, or is it that tube over there?
It needs labeled.
Oh, it's labeled? Okay, hang on. These both say hyper. Oh, this, I think it's this one.
Oh, right. Yeah, I forgot that they have different, right, naming convention.
Yeah. But yeah, no, I just. But when I start playing it now, I'm struck with a sudden, like, I've seen a lot of what this game can do.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, did you just fly past me?
Yep. Yeah, I'm going back because I need concrete.
Oh, that's right. Neither of us got concrete. But to me, before, I just, like, sat in silent wonder at this game. I was like, wow, there must be so much cool stuff you can do with it. And to be fair, there is. Mm-hmm. But I also was mystified by the amount of creative freedom it would bring, where it's like, man, you must be able to do so much with the physics and be able to, like, manipulate certain things. Like, it was like this futuristic time space, like, technology so advanced it's magic, and by therefore it must be super interesting to push this game to its absolute limits. But now that I've hit this point, I'm trying to really feel out how I feel about the game creatively. I don't know.
Yeah, I'll be honest. Part of this game and the buildup that I had to and enjoying this game to so late into this game was I found that I needed to play the game up to a certain point, and then I started getting frustrated with that point. And the reason I started getting frustrated is because I hadn't designed my factory to make my life as easy as possible in the long run. So then I you know, stopped playing it for a few months. I came back to it, started a new game, built the factory better
right
from the
crashed.
Beginning. Then
it froze again.
Oh no! I mean, it froze like just.
I was stuck in midair.
Outside of the hypertube?
Outside of the hypertube.
Weird! So weird.
Hot fixes. Wee woo. Not hot fixes. It's like an
updates?
It was a patch. Yeah, updates. Yeah. It was a real patch. That it just ingenuous to me to call it a hot fix. Because that's not what it was. It was a patch to improve the squash bugs.
Yeah.
Hot fixes are like things to try to fix the game as much as possible in a short span of time. Patches are star killing bugs. Killing bugs.
I think that makes sense, yeah. But what I was saying was, like, the loop for me with this game and, like, learning to enjoy it was partially avoiding the shit that makes it unenjoyable, which is all this tedium, right? This game hasn't been tedious up to this point, I hope, because we've just been, like, everything's been super straightforward. Because I designed the factory to be that way, and like we've made decisions in a very linear fashion, right?
Well, I think the only thing that's been tedious was when we started like the turbo fuel production, mm-hmm. or like we started that long-winded thing, and it's like where we started doing like the like going through the oil, getting that all set up, going to the desert, setting up everything. To pump it somewhere, to process it, to burn it, to connect it back to our power grid, and then
yep.
like getting all that power set up, that was tedious. I was like, okay, but I was like, you know, that's fair, because setting up power shouldn't be fun. It should be complicated, and there should be a lot of intense thought into how we do that. And
yeah,
like, at the end of the day, well, yeah, the original water plant where it's like we process coal from the water, that was kind of cool. I like that.
Yeah.
It was dealing with something, and I got to learn something about it.
It's
about how heads up
building,
works.
Yeah, whereas here we're now dealing with like multi-building processes. It's not super. Did I just freeze? Oh,
yeah, okay. I guess.
So, I see what you mean. Where you, like the game has stopped being where we could accomplish a task in a single stream.
Yeah, that's a thing. I think you're exactly right. It's like, and I think that's that might be a bit of a problem personally, where it's like, if maybe there's a way we can stretch this game a little bit to involve certain fun things. Like, I personally see the possibility of this game having a sort of surfing-esque thing about it, because like when I this jetpack, now that it's got turbo fuel, is fucking sick. Uh-huh. Like I can actually fine-tune my flight to such an extent that I could fly underneath this railway if I really needed to and not touch the ground. Mm-hmm. That's such a cool thing. I think you could really build like an obstacle course kind of thing where it's like you're slipping, you're sliding around, and you're just like going through it and it's circular. It's like I think that would be really cool, because this game does have a physics system that allows you for the finest tuning manipulation of your own movement.
Yeah.
Like the slipping, the sliding, the jumping, the blade running.
I gotta say the movement in this game is top notch.
Oh, definitely. I think that's, like, I think a part of the reason I've held on this long is just because it's fun to move around.
Yeah.
It's like, it's like this.
Coffee Stain has approached this developing this game with such the perfect mindset that like throughout the entire development of the game, it's like it has maintained a level of baseline quality that I would not have expected from such a so-called like indie game. Like this game, the concept for this game on paper is not as enjoyable as this game is. And the reason why it's enjoyable is because they got all the little things right. Like the movement is so satisfying once you like figure out you can slide, because goddamn, I didn't know I could slide when I started playing this game. And once I learned it, I was like, oh god, this is fun. And then you learn to slide jump and to get like extra distance, and then suddenly you're just always doing that. And there's so many things that they did right. Actually, I don't want that. With this game that makes it just like baseline enjoyable, and then the factory building itself is really the only part that still requires some tuning, it seems. Like they've made it a lot more enjoyable to build factories. I will say that. It's not as tedious as it used to be, because they added zooping, they added blueprints, they changed the gameplay loop a little bit, so like they changed recipes and things like that to make it as easy as possible. Well, not easy as possible, but like not unpleasant. Hey, could you two kindly stop being spiders?
That's like, that was like four spiders. Oh, never mind, there's only two. Oh, you picked up their stuff.
Yeah, there were two. There's a little clipping here, that's fine. I'll fix it later.
Yeah. I know, I just...
Yeah,
I think a big part of it that bugs me is that...
Oh, go ahead.
Well, I think it's just... Well, actually, no, never mind. I've taken the piss out of this game, and I don't think that's very fair of me.
Criticism is valid.
Well, yeah, I know it's valid. I just... The thing about it is, it's just like... I don't know if my criticism's necessarily as valid, because maybe this game's just not for me. Maybe it's like...
That's what I'm sort of thinking here, but at the same time, like... You seem to have enjoyed it so far, which is cool.
Well, yeah, no, I really want to be able to sort of enjoy the game, sort of, it's sort of like a uniqueness to how we have to approach a problem that actually has lateral thinking involved, I think is the word for it. Mm-hmm. Like, there's multitudes of solutions, and it's not just about, you know, finding a convoluted solution that works. It's finding a practical solution. And then, most importantly, it's finding an elegant solution.
Well, yeah, that's kind of what I was talking about, where, like, I think you're putting it way better than I did, where you're not just finding a solution, but you're also finding the best solution, because if you don't, then you're just making more work for yourself later.
Yeah.
Which is, it sounds actually quite tedious now that we say it that way.
Well, the thing about it is that it's not, I don't think tedium's the point.
No, it's not. Right? The point is accomplishing things and like, and being able to just like look at something you've done and bask in your own accomplishment, you know? Like, we did this. This is fucking awesome. Like,
yeah.
Have you seen our factory? It's beautiful looking. Like, that everything about it is, it does what it's supposed to, and we've, like, worked out all the bugs and shit. Like, it is a really good factory. And you know what? Like, we did that. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Where are we going from here?
No way. Idea.
This way. We need to go around these trees. And I think you'll benefit from listening to this music that I'm listening to, because it is chill, and I feel like you'd be way more relaxed.
Nothing could lower my blood pressure. Yeah, just I'm getting this sort of flipping where I'm from this one to the next.
Oh.
Let's see if I can't fix it. I think I can fix it. Hang
on. Yeah, it's not that much flipping. It's fine.
Yeah, it's perfect. Okay. Oh, yeah.
I can get rid of my.
So how does this look? Yeah, I mean, this is good. This is good.
It's fine.
It's good. Yeah.
Oh, great. A whole bunch of hatchers.
All right. Well, let's get our Noblesse out.
Noblesse?
All right. Yeah, we'll take care of it. Just try it. When we're ready, we'll throw one directly at one of them, and then that'll open them up.
If you aim beside them, then you don't have to worry about it.
Oh, shit.
Oh, one of them's dead. Just get the other one. Other one's dead. Alright.
Oh, were you next to my Noblesse explosion? Yeah. Fuck, I'm sorry.
Huh. Exploded. Alright. I'll leave that power slug. All right.
Yeah. So we can leave the power slug in its natural habitat.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Oops. Over the crash site. Okay, hey game, why is my foundation defaulting to rotate it like 45 degrees? I need to know. Oh, you want to go higher?
Just a little. Then if you can ramp them down, actually.
No, you maintain the same height over this crash site, and then we'll ramp down.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay, hang on, let me think ahead here.
I should have grabbed more steel pipe and stuff. Oh, it's
that way. Yeah. Okay. So we need to start... Are you out of steel pipe and beams?
I've only got about 100.
I've got a few stacks, so we should be fine to keep going.
Okay.
Thank you. By the way, I just want this clear and on stream as well. There is no obligation for either of us to play a game that we don't enjoy. If there's another game that we'd be more interested in playing on stream, we will play them on stream rather than a game that we don't enjoy. So just want to make that clear to everybody.
Yeah, but I know this talk we've been having sort of for a while, and I was we both agree that we were playing this game. We might talk about it and stuff and make crap about it. But I think we're not like forcing ourselves to play the game.
Yeah, we're not like some streamers who, you know, will play a game because their audience enjoys it even though they hate it. Or worse, like Reynar Vejas, who had to play Minecraft for like years without enjoying it for the most part. Like, you probably enjoyed it to start with, but I can't imagine that you could play Minecraft for that long without breaks and still enjoy it. Dude has Minecraft's the trigger word for him now, I think.
It's just at that level of fucking disdain.
But it was like, I mean, it brought in money for the company he worked for, and so it was like, yeah, fucking keep playing Minecraft. Keep it fun for the audience. Like, it was just like, yeah, all right. I mean, the audience enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. I thought it was really cool, like all the things that they managed to do in Minecraft. But it kind of stopped being about playing Minecraft after a time, and it was like, whatever. Even still, we're not going to be doing anything like that. If we ever, you know, decide that a game is not for us, we're going to stop playing it, on stream at least. And if we find out that it's not right for our audience, then maybe we'll just play it off stream and we'll pick something else. So,
yes, that is actually something we've talked about. I think that, so, that's why we are not currently playing Bug Fables anymore on stream, is just because we feel like we really weren't getting all that many people who were like really interested in it, so we just, you know, we'll move on to the next sort of project, and then we'll just go from there.
Yeah. So what I'm doing is I'm gonna play Bug Fables off stream because I think Penelope was right, that it is a really nice game. This is a steep incline.
Have you played it at all since we stopped streaming it?
No, I have not.
I feel it.
But that's partially because I need to get over that like feeling of like, Penelope needs to be here when I'm playing this. I can't just play this by myself. That feels rude somehow.
No, play it.
I know.
Play it, honestly. It's like, it's so much fun.
Is a 2 meter ramp going to be sufficient? I feel like a 2 meter ramp is probably about equal to the incline we're currently running on. Yeah. So we will work with the needs of our audience and the needs of ourselves. So if you guys have any feedback about anything we are playing, get out of here. No, if you have any feedback, don't get out of here. But please give us that feedback. If you want to toss in the comments, feel free to. We would have preferred it if you joined our Discord and gave us feedback through that, because that way we can refer back to it whenever we want. All in one place, but don't hesitate to leave a comment if you're not liking what you're seeing, or if you have a game that you think would be really fun to see us play, or anything like that. Or even if you want to just like toss a comment saying, hey, look, it feels like your guys aren't having fun, we'll listen to that sort of shit.
Yeah. Tell us your deepest, darkest desires. Tell us the things you dream about.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. Yeah, we do appreciate feedback.
We try to keep
our
own feedback
channel
loop going, but sometimes that's not enough.
Yeah.
Actually, this one needs to be flat for a little bit.
Deleting the track again. Hey, woo.
The unfortunate part is that I bet you a fair portion of this track might need to be redone. Oh, goodness, that's a big boy. There we go. honestly, I think part of the fun that we're having together is the like ability for us to just like enjoy a bunch of different games together. At least that's what I'm feeling.
I mean, I just feel like we're getting a good opportunity to just explore games and everything, and that's really cool. Like, yeah. I think it's fun to be able to stream stuff and be able to enjoy hanging with someone, finding new games, or trying things out. I just, like, I think it really helps cement, oh yeah, this is cool, I like this, this is kind of interesting. The sort of mentality where I can keep finding new and fresh things, and it's kind of nice to be able to do that.
It's also a platform to, without the usual difficulties of that would normally apply, we can easily just say, hey, I want to show you this game, let's play it on stream, you know?
Oh yeah,
like normally that's a really tough thing to do. I mean, at least in every friendship I've had up to this point, it's been like, yeah, you can recommend them a game all you want, they're not gonna play it. In fact, they might be less likely to play it because somebody's trying to get them to play it. You know, it's that weird innate spite that humans seem to have, where they're like,
I don't know if that's an ADHD thing, not a human thing.
You sure? Because I mean, it feels like everybody, maybe you just haven't had such a deep friendship before.
I mean, we recommend each other books and stuff. I mean, we were talking about books and everything, because would you like to talk about the book thing on stream, or is that something
which book thing?
On.
I mean, sure.
We're talking about your taste in books.
Oh, it's very hard to put a label on.
No, it's not. That's not the problem.
Oh, okay.
But I mean, I don't want to at you on stream.
I'm having my shit pushed in. Wait, did you say you don't want to call me out on stream?
No, I don't want to call you out on stuff on stream. Where it's like, that would be rude.
Well, these hogs are calling me out on stream, so I'm not super. I got aided. Where the fuck is it?
I can sense it somewhere. It's presence.
I sense its presence. Yeah, exactly.
I found it.
Where? Where was it?
It was instant. I looked in a direction. I instantly found it.
Oh, there. No, so I don't want to harvest Ada. Stupid Ada.
Ada compels me to kill.
I'm really upset with this game still. It has the most granular audio settings I have ever seen. Like, you can turn down the volume specifically for the rebar gun. Sorry. Oh no! Help! I'm being bullied.
Oh no!
I'm being bullied while I look in the settings. Okay.
I was answering IMs. Hang on. On that sweet AOL Messenger.
Dude, fucking AIMs? What? Okay.
The fucking.
What I was saying was you can change the individual volumes for say just fuel generators or just miners. Like, this has such granular shit. Except you can't fucking reduce the volume of the spooky Ada to zero. Like, she just not. It's not in the list. I'm so confused. I would like to just not play the game with those, please.
Yeah, no, I think honestly, you know what? This is a hot take. Why are these things in the game if they're not at all able to do anything? Why not just not have them in the game?
That is a question a lot of players in this game have asked. Period. End statement.
Let's just they're literally the only thing they're doing for us is they're taking up space in one of our chests back at the factory.
Yeah. Well, so they are story related, and yes, there's the argument that to be made that you could just not include them. Wow. Two, three! Lizard doggo.
Ooh! We found a pack.
Didn't know they had packs. Have we just been finding the lonely lizard doggos? The ones that are like not don't have a pack anymore? That sounds, we just made things sad. Oh
god. No, we give the lizard doggos that are alone a new pack.
I mean, the fact that we made their lives better doesn't change at the sadness. Like, orphans are still sad, even if they have a loving home now.
What did you? Orcas? Did you say?
I said orphans. Orcas
too. Oh, orphans.
Orcas too. Orcas are always sad. Fucking low, like sad noises they make.
That's yes. A sad noise.
Even if they have a good home now, they're still sad. Oh god! Oh no! Radiation! It's a radioactive
fuck
hog!
Fuck me sideways!
It's a radioactive hog! Oh god! Ah! Imminent destruction! I'm running away from the no, I gotta be near the train line if I'm gonna die. So I guess we found an enemy we haven't faced
before. I'm dead.
Before. You're dead?
I ran up to me and fucking killed me.
Okay, let's see if I can just rebar this shit to death.
I'm not carrying any rebar bullets. Any rebars, brush strips.
Oh no! That aura is a problem. Hey you. Okay.
Switch to your cam.
Right. Thank you. Let me go and get you. Where are you? I passed you. Oh no! All right, let's respawn, I guess.
That's good, yeah.
Shit. we need to figure out a solution to deal with that. Let's make a rifle. You've been excited about the rifle, right? We can do the rifle now.
Yeah. No. Sorry, I'm just handling a bunch of stuff in and out of.
Oh, okay.
I'm getting a bunch of IMs about something. It was related to the thing we were talking about earlier. So
why
I'm just
are you
on that.
It's specifically AIMs? Like you're on AOL Instant Messenger right
no,
now?
No, I'm saying IMs, not AIMs.
Oh, I was gonna say IMs is still weird.
Instant message. Oh, I guess it's fine. Okay, DMs. So I'm getting a lot of DMs
there
right
now. Yeah, there we go. Someone's
no,
slipping into your DMs.
All right, everybody. Thank you all so much for joining us tonight. I've been Penelope. He's been a little shit. Why is the inside of this room purple now?
Wait.
Thank you all so much for watching.
Is that it? Are we done? What's purple? Hold on, show us.
Everything's purple. Everything's purple. Why is everything tinted? Is it because the sun's rising?
It's because the sun is rising.
This entire room in here is purple.
I guess. Yeah, it's got a little bit of a purple tinge. I think it's because the sun's passing through the trees that are also purple. Over there.
Over where? Oh, yeah.
Okay, you can't see the trees, right? Because you're setting them up. Yeah.
There's trees over there. I see them right now.
I'm seeing way more trees than you are.
Oh, fucking. I guess I'm missing the forest with the trees then. In this scenario.
Yep. Are we actually done?
Well, we're at about 2.5 hours. You know, I feel like this is a good point to stop for the night.
You wanna build a rifle?
Well, let's. God, I hate you.
I tripped into that one. I mean, come on, you can get a rifle before, and then just like fuck around with that before we end the stream. No?
That's real dangerous to give me a gun. It'd just be like, yeah, here, go nuts. That's real dangerous,
I'm
not gonna lie.
It's very different from the last time I used it, so it might actually be worthwhile.
Well, don't we need smokeless powder?
Can't we make that our. Oh, we can. It has to be done at a refinery.
Alright, I'm kidding. You know what? Yeah, we're gonna have to go. In order to get a rifle, we're gonna have to.
We're gonna have to
go play with refineries.
Smokeless powder requires. What does it require? How do we? Hold on. Okay, So smokeless powder, refinery, heavy oil residue, and gunpowder. We could manually do that. You already got heavy oil residue available to us. We just manually create a bunch of smokeless powder. Want to do that?
Well, shouldn't we automate the process at all? Like, should we?
Well, yeah, so you can automate it later. That process is going to take a few extra steps to automate, but at least this way, this one we can do relatively manually to start with. Because to automate it, all we have to do is we just go over to our oil refinery and we add our oil, whatever, the oil thing. And then we add a refinery, but we then have to get gunpowder over to it, which we can't do from the factory because that would be backtracking, and we don't do that.
That would be a sin.
It would be. It's the only commandment. Thou shalt not backtrack. So we would have to create a new gunpowder line that is made for the smokeless powder. And so we would have to find some sulfur and some coal, which sulfur, I realize, is very rare. I think there's some sulfur nearby, though. They're not showing up. Oh, they're not showing up on the map because I don't have the ores on the map. Yeah, there's some sulfur, like, right next to the base. And there's also some sulfur right next to our oil plant. And coal! So it'll be super easy. Smokeless powder will be a piece of cake. We just to automate, but it's going to take some steps that probably will take longer than we want to stream for.
Okay. Well then.
So, do we want to just grab some gunpowder, head over to the oil plant, hook something up to the heavy oil residue, and just make it right now?
Yeah, I don't have a parachute anymore, so I'm probably gonna have to walk.
There's fuel in this container over here. Where'd you go?
Oh, okay.
I keep fuel for emergency. Actually, wait. I think we can build a. I've got fabric here. I can just build more parachutes if you want to.
Oh, that's good.
We need cable.
Yeah, we should probably grab some supplies to do things. I've got some gunpowder in my inventory. Or black powder. Then we can go build some smokeless powder.
Normal fuel is always no. I'm gonna need to stockpile some turbo fuel on the factory. Where's the cable? Screws? Cable? Is this cable? Oh, it's got two in line. And then we can make a parachute. Make two parachutes. A pair of parachutes, even. Where are you at?
I'm in the middle of the blueprint designer.
Okay. I'll toss you a parachute. Oh, it's even got like a little pack in it when it's on the ground. I didn't realize that.
That's cute.
Somebody designed that. That's nice. Okay.
Yeah.
We need. Actually, there's already a refinery there, so we don't actually need to worry about bringing the resources for a refinery. So let's just head over there.
Okay. We don't need any resources.
You didn't need a parachute because there's a turbo. There's a hyper.
Oh, is it? I thought it was right here, or right there. Or where is it?
Hyper two.
Oh no! I thought. Never mind. I'll just follow you then. Oh no.
What do you mean, oh no?
I was just getting a lot of like glitches as I was walking through that hyper too.
Oh yeah. Okay, and then we go over to one of these refineries and we just convert it. So I'll take this lift off. It's already taking in heavy oil residue, so we just switch it to powder. You toss a bunch of. I don't have any black powder on me.
I've got black powder. Where are you?
There we go. And let's increase the production speed to full speed again. How much do we need? I'll head back to mid.
No, it's cool. Let's just chill out here. That's okay.
Well, we gotta know when we need to go back. So I'm gonna go back.
Maybe we just
so
wait
we
till
know,
this
so
is.
We need to know when we go back.
All right.
Hang on, it'll take 2 seconds. Sorry, So, of the 3 games we're currently playing, I'm curious, which one are you most enjoying?
Baldur's Gate.
Still?
Yeah.
Alright. We need 50 Spokeless Powder. Okay.
Okay. Well, I brought, like, quadruple the amount we're gonna need to make that number, so we're fine.
Honestly, even though I'm kind of like sidecarring it, it's I've been having a lot of fun just with the amount of stupid shit we're doing. Just like the side stories that we were telling. It's so good. Not to mention, the game is nice to return to.
Oh yeah, I'm really enjoying Minish Cap right now.
It's got the best art aesthetic.
Yeah, it's good.
So I'm a bit biased as somebody who enjoys cartoony things.
Well, I enjoy cartoony things as well. Hell, I really enjoyed stuff like Sly Cooper, which is like super animated, cel shaded, like living comic book style. It's so cool.
Oh yeah.
I could talk for ages about Sly Cooper to someone. Have I talked about it with you?
Sly Cooper? Not very much, no.
I remember at one point, we were playing this game, but it was before we started streaming it, that I realized your voice sounds remarkably like the voice of Sly.
Oh yeah, you had me like do some lines.
I had you do a line from, I think, the second game? I think it was the second game. Mm-hmm. And, like, after a couple of takes, you fucking knocked it out of the park. I was like, whoa! You sound just like the guy. I was like, I was incredibly impressed. Because I was actually, I'd never heard anyone do, like, that good of an impression of Sly Cooper before.
I have never found a character's voice that matches my own. Ever.
You sound like maybe a more nasal Sly Cooper, like you, like. But when, huh? What the?
Oh, we're streaming right now. Would you mind?
You're beautiful. Bye.
Thanks.
Heyo. That I was so confused. I was like, "What just happened?" That was fun.
That was April. She's one of our other mods. She's actually co-streamed with me a couple times in the past.
Oh yeah.
It's a little shocking.
No, I was just like, I was shocked because I was like, did something just happen to our Discord?
Oh yeah, it scares you into thinking like somebody was like hacked our Discord or something. Yeah.
Alright, I fell off the puff.
I knew that the only other person that could access the voice channel was lost. Safe.
I'm glad you have an intuitive understanding of our current systems, because I sure didn't for a second there.
Well,
that was scary to me. It's super cool to have.
It's like that thing where you live in a house by yourself, everything stays where you put it. The moment you start living with somebody else, it's like why do am I suddenly having such a difficulty keeping track of my shit? And it's because people move shit around. And it's like, huh. The moment you add a second person to an equation, it's like, well, great. Now suddenly nothing is certain.
Yeah.
I've got enough of the smokeless powder for the MAM upgrade. I think we'll need more for like the actual building of the gun and stuff, but
I've got 50 more.
Okay, cool. Let's leave that running for a moment and we can go back.
Okay.
We'll go.
Actually, you know, I'll put the rest of my black powder in there.
Oh yeah, good call.
I'll just have that cooking for when we come back. I should just fucking walk it.
Ah, give it a try.
I don't want to crash the game.
I mean, it won't crash the game for me. So there's zero risk.
And I'm very happy for you that that's the scenario you get to live in. Fortunately, I'm not in that scenario. Ooh.
Okay, I'm gonna go grab the 100 motors and 200 rubber that we need. Oh shoot, the rubber was on the oil platform. Hang on, I'll grab the motors and the rubber is somewhere in our factory. Motors are on this one. Right? Yeah. One, two, three. Okay. I bet that looked super weird to everybody on stream because a third icon just appeared. Side art. Okay.
So oh, did it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, anybody who's in the voice channel can, it like shows up on the overlay.
Oh, wow.
Rubber and cable. Is it this one?
So motors and rubber. Okay.
This one? No. That was all the rubber.
Oh yeah, did the update make all of our signs blank, or am I just not seeing them anymore?
I can see them. You can't. That's a multiplayer bug that they know about. Yes,
okay.
The update did break that, yes.
Oh, good.
Thankfully, they do still have stuff on them. It's just that right now, multiplayer's clients are not capable of seeing them. So.
Well, I mean, as long as it works, then it's fine. But I have no idea what anything is, so I can't really go up and down the stairs without getting lost.
Okay. We're gonna get rifle. I appreciate that they took all of these research things and they stopped them taking longer than 3 seconds, because it used to be that way. It kind of sucked. Oh, we can make explosive rebar now, too. They require smokeless powder, too, though, so eh.
That's, yeah.
Okay.
So we made the rifle and rifle ammo. That's cool.
So now how... Oh, you're using it. Okay. Let's see.
We need 3 copper sheets and 2 smokeless powder to make rifle ammo.
What about right?
2 motors, 10 rubber, 25 steel pipes, and 250 screws.
Okay, you want to get the steel pipes and screws, and I'll go find the rubber wherever the fuck that was again.
Steel pipes and screws. I can get that.
So steel pipes,
that should be
first
floor, and second
screws,
floor.
Second floor.
Yes. Just gotta remember steel pipes and screws. Steel pipes and screws.
On the wrong floor.
Fifth. Steel pipes. And screws. Cool.
Wait. Oh, okay. I was gonna say, I was just looking at your screen for a moment there, and I was like, is resources clipping through the vertical conveyor belts?
Or was not every bug squash can be perfect, right?
Yeah, well, multiplayer is an issue right now. Hey, you need these resources, right? Rubber?
I need the rubber.
Thank you.
Remember when we used to have to craft stuff like this?
Oh, yeah.
Remember they used to be our lives?
Oh, hey, we can increase our inventory because we got the rifle, so now the inflated pocket dimension is available to us. 50 smokeless powder and 50 circuit boards.
Nice. Do you, can you go grab some copper sheets for me real quick? So I can make us some ammo?
Yeah.
Just like a full stack of them.
Pocket dimension that we can unlock everything now, but it'll just be. I think there's one that we still need from just random hard drive drops.
I see.
But that one we haven't seen yet. And then there's another one. Or there's a few that are in. I think this. Yep, there's 3 inventory spots, and there's 3, and that's it. Wow, we're so close to having all the inventory. Look at that guy.
I made you one.
Oh, sweet.
I made you some ammo. How do I aim down the sights?
You don't.
What? It's a rifle!
I've said it before, this game is not designed as a first person. There are no sights.
Who designed? Oh, April, you're fine. April, you're fine. It's okay. You're totally fine. But who doesn't aim down the door? What? This is a gun!
I know. Hey, you want to take the circuit boards and some of your smokeless powder and upgrade our inventory?
Oh, sure, yeah. I don't have enough.
Shit! All right, back to the thing. Now with gun in hand, I did you notice the little like fix-it charm that just like kind of dangles?
Yeah, it's cute.
Yeah.
It's better than my Xenobasher, because my Xenobasher's wrench charm doesn't work anymore.
Oh, it doesn't?
It just fucking sits there. It's kind of waves really, really slowly.
Oh,
and
God.
Super fucked up texture. It's like, oh yeah, this has been broken for like at least 5 or 6 streams now, maybe even longer.
Good.
Like if you look at my, you see how like it doesn't even look like a wrench.
Oh, it doesn't have a thing hanging from it. Oh yeah,
it doesn't.
It's just like low poly. Holy heck.
What's your what? Are you already coming back? Oh.
You didn't take the hypertube.
Because it kicks me. I have to be the peace I seek. I have to be the peace I seek. I have to be.
Yeah, keep telling yourself that. It'll make my life even more enjoyable.
I just feel a deep violence in my heart. Man, maybe I shouldn't spare kobolds. Fuck.
Hey, that's going too far.
I love kobolds. Kobolds are nice.
Some kobolds are nice. Some kobolds are fucking dicks.
Yeah. Before I met you, my only understanding of kobolds is that they're pure, like, maybe not sadists, but they're trap savants.
Yeah.
That's their whole game. Or is it?
Is sadism the one where you like pain on others, or is it masochism?
Pain on others is sadism.
Okay. Did you already get some
pieces? Right. No, I
don't. Oh, that's a big container.
Ah, that's a lot of smokeless powder.
It looks huge on, like, in the world. It's like, oh my god, that's a lot of explosives in one container. Hey!
Yeah, I don't...
More inventory space!
No way. There's gotta be more.
What?
Look at our inventory slots.
Oh yeah, so we're 12 away from the all right, time to turn. We're 12 away from the maximum.
Yeah, so that means there's another upgrade to do, right?
So there are two upgrades from the thank you for the hydrate, by the way. There are two upgrades
from water right now.
The milestones. So hazmat suit gives us 3, and then hover pack gives us 3. And then there's a 6th one that's in a hard drive somewhere.
Oh.
I think you can only get that one if you get unlock a certain tier or something, or like a certain thing in the tier system. Because some hard drive stuff is not available until you reach a certain milestone.
Can you stand like right there? Fuck. Right. Hang on. With alt click right there.
What, right here?
Just right there. Hold, stick.
What?
Now hold still, and actually you need to hold still, okay?
Alright.
How accurate is that? That's... Wow, that's actually not that bad, huh?
Yeah.
You thought I was gonna shoot you.
So the rifle, there's no drop, but it has a certain limit to its range.
Oh, I see. So this isn't like a... What's its range?
150 meters.
I'm gonna have to think about
each one of these squares is 8, so it's 20 of these basically.
Well, yeah, so we could shoot from here to the window, and we about hit the end of it.
Yeah, this is not a long range weapon. Nothing in this game is long range. Mostly because then the game would have to render things long range, and that would be really bad.
Okay, I do have a criticism of this game. Gunplay needs to be overhauled immediately.
It's not a gunplay game. It's a factory game.
I know.
The factory people may not want gunplay, and you know what? In this game, the guns are meant to be very simple, and they are.
If the guns are, be the peace you seek. Be the peace you seek. Be the peace you seek.
Hey, I love gunplay as much as
we love seeing you, April. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Have a great night. Gunplay is great. I like gunplay. But I think that they made the right choice. This game does not need extra gunplay mechanics because the game doesn't need extra complexity. Aim down sights is an extra keybind.
No, it's not. Because you know what I'm doing when I'm running around right now? My right mouse button isn't key to anything.
Right,
do you know what it could do?
The cancel button. It's the back out of what you're currently doing button.
But if I have something in my hands, I'm not doing anything with it. So this can easily also double as a zoom function.
I mean, sure. It does do something. I guess your argument is valid.
I know, it's just like, look. I totally understand this is not a gunplay game. I get that. And I'm willing to subscribe to that philosophy and viewpoint. That makes sense because we're factory workers and engineers.
Yeah.
We're not soldiers. And I understand that, you know, I'll even be willing to say it took a long time for us to get what we're holding in our hands right now because it's so far off our beaten path that we essentially had to go looking for it, which I get. The fact that we can't aim down the sights as a result of all of our hard work, and the fact that a rifle just inherently is meant to be a gun that's at medium to long range, and we just can't aim down the sights for better accuracy even at medium range, that's horseshit. I don't know what amount of copium I need to take to make that make sense, but I'm clearly not taking enough.
Oh yeah. Hold up.
But yeah.
Oh geez, we need 1,000 rounds of regular rifle ammo in order to make the turbo rifle ammo. Oh, and aluminum casing. Never mind. All right, so that's out of the question for the moment. Let's get some more ammo, and then we're gonna go get our shit back.
Oh, is that what we're doing?
What do you mean? Of course. No. What do you want to do? We're not gonna leave the shit there until next stream.
Why not?
That just feels like, I don't know, it just...
We're going on a hunt next stream.
We might forget about it next stream. It's not gonna take that long.
Here, love, I want you to do something for me. I want you to shoot me in the leg. Because I always shoot you, and you always have to deal with it.
I thought it was like, so you can leave?
No, I need you to shoot me in the leg.
So you can get an honorable discharge?
No. I want to know how much...
I missed.
Try again. That does nothing!
Ah.
What the fuck?
It's a fully automatic weapon with 15-round magazine. Yeah, it doesn't do very much damage.
This is a gun! It puts holes in your body and your internal... Ah! What do you mean it doesn't do that? Sure, it doesn't do the equating of fucking shooting rebars in your abdomen, but Jindra, huh?
You know what? I think on a person, your argument is valid. However, considering the amount of health that the fauna of this planet has is relative to the amount of armor plating they have, I feel like this is more valid of an argument.
That's fine, but I should have taken like two pips of my health.
Rebar deals 2 bars. Rifle deals 2 bars. Hang on, let's compare rifle to the other thing.
No, this still dealt a half of a bar.
No, sorry, I'm looking at the ammo. The ammo has a damage thing. It's 2 out of 5. Rifle is 2 out of 5 as well. Hang on. How much damage did that do?
It did a bar and like 2 pips.
Wait, really?
Yeah. Ow!
Oh yeah, look at that. So I guess the damage bars are on the ammo is a lie. Or it's based on like damage per second or something.
No, it's gotta be... Maybe it's not trying to tell us its literal amount of hip health it's dealing. Maybe it's just on a scale of like compared to all the other ammo types.
Well,
like,
it's not just that, because the rifle ammo is also 2 out of 5 bars. So they should be roughly equivalent to each other, and they're not. So it's got to be per second or something.
Hold still. I'm going to take... No, don't run up. I was going to see if I can hit you from there, but that's fine. Well, don't run up there. Ah.
You said... What?
Did I hit you?
Yeah.
Hang on. How much damage did I do?
Like a third of a bar?
A third or 2/3?
Like, maybe half?
Wow. So.
But it's got a high fire rate, which is good.
I'm just stunned a little.
It's also way easier to aim. It's not the amount of damage it does. It's the accuracy and fire rate that makes it better than the other.
I do see that there's a like, very small spread on this. It's actually nice.
Oh yeah, there's zero functional recoil, and just the artificial recoil of the thing, the circle expansion. I'm gonna get some more resources.
I'm out of ammo.
Yeah, I'm almost out too.
All right, well, let's call it here, and then we'll go do this next time. Cause like, I don't want to have to travel all the way across the map to hunt. I think we can make it a next time thing. We've got guns in our hands. We'll have some American music playing next time, where it's like America, fuck yeah, or something like that. Is it? Yeah, probably. I mean, it's a song about America. Of course, it's fucking copyrighted.
Yeah, I'm gonna switch this back to just doing Patrol and Coke. That way, we don't lose functionality on this thing.
No worries.
What resource do I need? What is going on? I think I need some iron plates or something, because I don't have any of the resources for any of my conveyor lifts. Fuck. Alright, I'll fix this after the stream's over. Hey, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the stream and the shenanigans we've gotten up to today. It wasn't
Sorry we got kind of introspective on the game.
It wasn't much shenanigans, I'll admit, but that's fine. And the introspection was... Hey, you know what? No, we kept it real, okay?
Yeah.
That's good. You know, if you guys don't want us to keep it real, I mean, tell us in the comments.
No, don't tell us that in the comments. I'm just
we won't listen to you, but I mean, the engagement would be appreciated. but all the same, if anybody, share what you think of our like music overlay. Compliment me, damn it. Otherwise, or you know, tell me how I could do it better. Do you like the way the kobolds light up, or do you think that I could do it a different way? Either way.
No, we're keeping that.
Oh, well, of course we're keeping it. It's gorgeous. I'm just saying. Prove me wrong, internet. That's what I'm saying.
No. No, he didn't mean that.
I may have meant it.
No, he didn't.
Either way.
I'm speaking for you.
Shush, I'm speaking for you.
Exactly.
Either way, thank you all for watching. Have a great rest of your night. Make sure to join the Discord if you do want to interact with us on a more regular basis and be able to see our stream schedule and all that fun stuff. Speaking of stream schedule, we'll be back on Wednesday for a continuation of Penelope's Minish Cap playthrough, where I make really shitty voices.
We make really fun voices. I don't want to... Don't put down my friend shitty. On stream like that.
They're fun and shitty, okay? Like not like shitty as in their awful voices, just shitty as in their they're not bad like mechanically. They're just bad culturally.
Oh, I get you.
I was gonna
make a voice, but I can instantly tell from the feeling in my heart that I was going to cause some major peak on my mic. So, you know, I'm going to upgrade my sound setup sooner or later, hopefully.
Sooner or later.
You know, I get paid next this week, so. Oh. All right, everyone. We'll have a wonderful night. Don't forget to be awesome.
Hey, speaking of which, if you guys want to support us and help Penelope upgrade her sound setup, feel free to subscribe to our Twitch channel or send us some bits.
Yeah, we love bits.
Yeah, love to shove them in my mouth. Either way, thank you for watching. Have a great rest of your night, and we'll see you on Wednesday. Bye, everyone.
See you on Wednesday.
Do the thing.
Don't forget to be awesome.
Do not forget to be awesome. Good night, everybody.